Okay, I think we're live. I think we're still live. This is hilarious. It basically stops and starts, and I can't tell if it's still going. This is kind of a work in progress, so I apologize. If you've been watching this whole thing, this debacle, then yeah. Anyways. Maybe for the third time, I have no idea, but I am building a streaming computer for my church live, and I have already put together some of the parts, and this is hilarious because I'm not sure if it's actually going through. Yes, it is definitely okay. We are definitely streaming right now. Awesome. Okay, I see that we are definitely streaming. This is hilarious. So welcome to the channel. It's Joe Wills Art. This is not a drawing. This is not a drawing episode. This is basically me trying to flounder my way through a PC build. So I set up all this for a live stream. And basically, this was more of a test to see if it can be done, but also it was kind of a sending out my feelers just to see what is going to work on the channel. So I apologize if we're starting off a bit rough, because I don't know if you noticed, but the motherboard is already out. The processor is already in. We went with an AMD 7, Ryzen 7, 36, 3700, X. We also went with the Corsair LPX DDR4, 16 GB RAM and our memory. So we have two of those, which is 32 GB of memory. So this is an MSI board, and it's the B450A Pro Max. I'm going to be adding a Radeon RX 580 graphics card to that and a few other things. So, yes, it has been a long night. I just got back from doing grocery shopping a bit earlier, obviously, and then I decided to go ahead and do a live stream, which probably wasn't the smartest thing, mainly because I'm very tired at this point. But I really wanted to get this done. I wanted to build this computer. I wanted to have it recorded. So essentially, this is the streaming computer for my church. I'm the technology director at my church, and I'm basically in charge of all the technology that goes on there. And as such, I want to make sure that we have the best possible video or streaming for our services, seeing as how the global pandemic doesn't seem to be going away anytime soon. So, in an effort to keep our congregation together, we wanted to make sure we have very reliable sound and video for our streaming. And in order to do so, I wanted to make sure we had a good computer. And it looks like I am way out of focus. I have no idea what's going on with this autofocus for the camera here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Maybe we should just put it on manual focus. That's probably what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna put it on manual focus and see what's going on here. Maybe that's why it's not focusing, because the monitor is not allowing it to. All right. Again, growing pains and technical difficulties. I'm just going to put it back on manual focus and see if it finds me. Did it find me? Yeah. All right, cool. So yeah, we're doing the PC build, and that's what we are doing today. I have an overhead camera set up so we can always have a top down, and I'm going to switch back and forth between the two because you don't need to necessarily see my face for most of this. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to grab the rest of the parts, slap them on here as best as possible, get all the wires wired up, and then go ahead and put it in into the case, excuse me, and work from there. Okay, so as of right now, I just realized, so we want to put the SSD in. I'm just going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and open this up, which I think I've already done that more than once now, seeing as how the stream false started a few times. So yeah, let's check this out. All right, so I see that we have a couple. Jordan, oh hey, happy to see you live. Let's see, I'm happy you are live for this. Is your computer good, running order? Oh, yeah. So Jordan, this is the computer for my church. Mine is good. Mine is good. It's working pretty good. As a matter of fact, I'm using it. It's a stream right now. But because I built my computer, I did the PC build. We wanted to make sure we had a good computer for streaming at the church, because we wanted to make sure we have some reliable, basically make sure the computer was reliable enough to handle a stream, because that's basically how we're doing all of our services. They're going to be live streamed on Sundays and Wednesday nights. So yeah, I'm just building up a new computer because our computer was severely lacking in power and everything, basically. So I'm just doing that now. I'm botching this because mainly because of the fact that I don't know if you notice, or if it may even be on my channel, there's probably two or three other streams, because I'm using OBS, and OBS likes to do a live stream on its own and just not tell YouTube, and YouTube is like, I don't know what you're talking about, you're not streaming right now. So when I hit stop, there's a new stream started. So just craziness. Anyway, so I'm gonna go ahead and pop this SSD in, and actually it looks like it might be too short, so I'm gonna have to grab one of the screw posts, which are in the box. Every one of these SSDs come with little manual, and I thought it came with the, oh, you know what? I think it's on the, came with the motherboard, I think. Yeah, the motherboard should have some screws, some little screw posts. Let's check. I hope. They better. Let's see, this is the plate. Is there anything in there? Nope, there's nothing in there. Hopefully this table doesn't get too messy while I get this together. Let's see, we got stickers for that. Nope. There we go. So we have the M.2 screw, but we need the post. Where is the post? I took everything out of the box. So did it fall? Let's see. Okay. That's That's where, oh, it's already in there. It's just further out. I'm sure somebody's screaming at the camera, screaming at me. Let's see. I just got the notification for the stream. I got here when you said we are live. Oh, awesome. Okay. So then I guess that worked out. That's awesome. Let's see. You may be the only one watching, which is totally fine. We can hang out. Oh, that's not small enough. So I need to get this screw post out and pull it closer. Let's see what I got in the tiny little jeweler's bag here. Let's see what I got. I need cross tip. I don't think this is big enough. Let's try this one. Let's try a flat. Nope. I won't break it. So, I'm on my art desk right now, and I have a tablecloth on it to make it look nice and purdy. But, can you see it on the camera? But a lot of my tools are still in the drawer here. So I'm just going to pull out the drawer and see what we have. I need my screwdriver, which I thought I had. I thought I pulled that out already. And my girlfriend's listening. She's probably shaking her head like, you are so unprofessional, ill-prepared. What is the deal? Okay, so I need a screwdriver. I may have to call her in to get that screwdriver because I keep realizing also that the audio, the camera, or the microphone is up there, and I'm talking to my chin. Let's see. Could have sworn I had one in here. May have gotten pushback. No. Okay. So no biggie. So I'll just need to grab a screwdriver. Hey, babe. Can I get your help? Sage Empress. Hey. Hey, Sage Empress. How are ya? Camera and sound are on point. Thanks, Jordan. I appreciate that. I'm trying to make sure that all the cameras and everything is nice and clean and the audio is clean. Can I get a cross tip screwdriver, the smallest tip that's in the drawer there? I thought I had it out already, but I do not. Just yet. Okay. While that is happening and we are getting everything together. So in case you just joined us, I am building a computer here for our church. We're doing a stream. We basically stream our services every Sunday and Wednesday, and we wanted to get a more powerful computer, a more reliable computer to do that. The problem was the computer that we have was a bit old. It was antiquated. I think it was an old Dell or something like that. I think it was maybe a couple $100 at like Walmart or something. And we've had it for a little minute now, and it is pretty much on its last legs. There's a lot of stuff going on with it. I could have spent some time to optimize it and kind of maybe even swap out some parts and things like that, but I just want to start from scratch, just get something perfect, brand new, you know, with all the bells and whistles, well, some of the bells and whistles, and get that up and going. So basically what we have here is the MSI B450A Pro Max motherboard, we also have the Ryzen 7, it's a 3700X processor, and then we have two DDR4 Corsair LPX memory sticks. So we have those in there, and I'm basically just going through the motions of putting this all together. And hopefully when I put it all together, it'll turn on. I know mine didn't initially, and I freaked out. I really did. Anyone that was involved in that situation, because I posted it on Facebook, and I was extremely freaking out because I just spent a whole lot of money on that computer. Luckily, I didn't spend the money on this one, but I do feel responsible for this. I want to make sure that it works, obviously, and just want to make sure that I don't like spit on a microphone. But yeah, so I'm just waiting for the for a screwdriver because this one is too big and the other one that I have is too small for this particular little screw here, which I might be able to get with my fingers, but I don't think so. It's just not coming out. So let's see this one here. Let's see if this works. That might be too good. Oh, whoa. Okay, well, that doesn't stay. Oh, there we go. Yeah, this one doesn't. It's too big. Let's try that one. This might work. Yep, that one did it. Awesome. Thank you. Okay, so we just pulled this out here. I'm just going to hold on to the tools here. We just pulled this little screw post out. Just going to make that. Push that closer. Let's see where it needs to go. We need to go one more out. All right, so that's in. We're just going to hand tighten that. I don't want to break the board here. So we're just going to pop that bad boy in there. Awesome, that's in. And then we're just going to push that down. Actually, we want to grab the screw. It's a tiny little screw. This thing, this little tiny screw on my last one, I dropped it. I cut it out of the video though, because I edited that video. I didn't do that one live, but I dropped it, and it took forever to find this tiny little screw. And I learned my lesson. I have black tablecloth on my table here, so I can see any little silver screw, and I have a big light on it, so I can see any little silver screw that might fall on it. I can just find it instantly, because it's, you know, it'll catch the light and be against the black, and it'll be really easy to find. Now, if it falls on the floor, it's a whole different situation. We have concrete floors. It will bounce forever, and I probably will never see it again. But let's hope that doesn't happen. And I think I just pulled all the plastic with it. That's just great. All right. So, again, if you're tuning in and you go to the channel, if you're a subscriber to my channel, you'll know that essentially I am a comic book artist. And actually, right now, I'm currently working on a comic book. It's called Veil of Night. And basically, we kind of went back to the drawing board a bit with the story. So I am actually currently writing and drawing that story. And my editors are probably looking like, Joe, this is definitely not a Veil of Night video. This video is not even art related. Like, what's going on here? Did you quit? What's going on? No, I did not quit. I just had some other responsibilities that I had to take care of, and I figured I'd make a YouTube video out of it. And I am ham-fisting this because my fingers are so large. Let me grab my jeweler screwdriver. Let's see. Nope, no, that's flat tip. I need a cross tip. I have this little baggie of jeweler screwdrivers. I used to work at a cell phone company, and I used to use these type of tools all the time to go into phones and things like that. And when I did, I was like, man, I'm definitely going to have to buy a set just like this because of little things that I need to take apart. Like, I can't think of anything. I only use it for this computer. All right, so we have the SSD in there. And let's see who we got in the chat. Sage Empress, I'm okay, and yourself? I'm very well. I'm a bit tired. Had a pretty long day today. From this morning all the way till now, I think I've been doing a lot of running around outside, but it's been nice outside here in St. Louis, so I can't complain. Let's see, who else we got? Comic Book Bob. Comic Book Bob is in the house. Hey, what's up? I didn't see it. Sorry it took so long to get to the chat. Let's see, I'm going to have you build my next PC, Joe. I wouldn't advise that. Let's see how this one goes first. This is really my second PC that I've ever built in regards to the newer PCs. Now, back in the day, like when I was in high school and even a little bit after that, I built PCs, but they were a whole different animal. Whole different animal. Wow, I must be really tired. All of this is much different from what I'm used to. from back in the day. I'm used to the large, thick cables and tons of, you know, big, huge hard drives and things like that. And I'm out of focus. This is crazy. Let's just see if we can get this focus here. Come back to me. Come back to me. All right. And it's not going to do it. Okay. So we're just going to switch it to manual. And we're going to focus it in and do it that way. That's perfect. Okay. So, yeah, back in the day, I used to put together computers. I used to fix computers all the time, mainly because my father kept breaking them. But I would have to go in and, you know, install Windows and change out hard drives, kind of the easy stuff, nothing really too complicated. Occasionally, I would have to change out a memory stick or two, but I never really had to touch the processor or anything like that. And all of those cables were huge cables, like those huge honking cables. I think I might still have some in the closet somewhere, which I know my girlfriend wants me to throw those away because I'm a pack rat. But yeah, I mean, so this is totally different. Everything is so tiny. Everything is so small. And all the screws are super small and everything lights up with LEDs and things like that. So yeah, this is a bit outside of my comfort zone, but that's the only way you really kind of learn. You have to push yourself outside of your comfort zone in order to get to a point where you know, get to new things. So, but yeah, I'm just having a blast putting this stuff together. Let's see who else is in the chat here. We got John. Oh, you're saying hey to Comic Book Bob. Holla. Yeah. So, yeah, let's go ahead and move forward. We have the CPU in, we have the memory in, and we also have the hard drive in. This tiny little thing is a hard drive. It blows my mind because back in my day, you couldn't even hold a hard drive with your hand. It was so big. But yeah, the hard drives back in the day used to be huge, huge, big, heavy things with, like, you know, inside of them is like a silver disc and all this kind of stuff. And now it's just this tiny little memory stick, basically. But anyway, that's enough reminiscing. Let's move forward. Let's go to the future. All right. So we've got the motherboard together. We have all this stuff. We need to basically get this motherboard into the case so we can add the cooler, because the cooler has these two huge fans on it that's going to be connected to the front face of the motherboard. So before we do that, we probably want to put the power supply in the motherboard as well. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm just going to clean up a little bit. And because this is live, you're going to watch me clean up, grab all this stuff and just kind of throw it off to the side, because that's how I clean up. Again, if you talk to my girlfriend, you'll know. When I clean up, I usually just kind of push it all under the under the couch and under the bed. And if you see under my desk, you probably... Anyway, so let's push this off to the side and hopefully we can keep that safe. And we're going to grab the case. And actually, you know what? Let's do this. Let's grab the power supply first. All right. So we have an EVGA power supply. It is the 80 plus gold. Let's put it under here so you can see. Sorry about that. All right. So got a lot of light reflecting off of there, so you kind of see what my light setup looks like. All right, so it's a 650 watt, mainly because the graphics card that we're putting in, it's not super high power graphics card. We don't really plan on doing other than having the oh my goodness, I just realized, do we even have the Blackmagic card? So we should have another card added to this. We're supposed to be getting a Blackmagic card, which actually has multiple HDMI ports, which I just realized we don't have, which probably means we need to make sure that order is in. And I'll take a look around. I don't think I have it here. If I don't have it here, then it must be still at the church. We can still build the computer, no big deal. We can still put everything in. But this is the 650 gold power supply by EVGA. I have the, I want to say the 850, but that's because I have this huge graphics card, which is the, I think it's the GT what was it? I can't remember what it was. It was like a 280, RTX 280 or something like that. The big boy is like black edition. So I figured they didn't really need all of that. We didn't need all of that, mainly because of the fact that we're just going to be streaming. And again, like I said before, we're not going to be gaming or video editing or anything like that. If there's a video that needs to be edited, if they have something, Pastor wants to kind of do some kind of video in which we that needs editing, I'll probably just upload it to Google Drive and just take care of it when I get home, because I have, you know, the Adobe Creative Suite with which all the, you know, or the Creative Cloud or whatever it's called now, that I pay monthly for. So I might as well use it for something that's very productive other than just art. Because I really just use the Photoshop for the most part. So let's open this up and we're going to cut away. Swing away. Swing away. Somebody in the chat telling me where that's from. Swing away. Oh no, I don't think they said it like that. I think it was just swing away. It's from what was it from? Was it from? I think it was an M. Night Shyamalan Ding Dong movie. M. Night Shyamalan movie. I'm pretty sure it was. Let's see what we got. Let's take a look at the chat. Let's see, Joe, man of many talents. Good voice acting. Good voice acting. Did I do the voice? I don't even know what I say anymore. I literally just, I'm just that tired to the point where I don't even hear what I'm saying. why is this not working? Oh, there we go. Yeah. Gotta be smarter than the box, Joe. That's gotta be smarter than the box. Let's just, let's try not to hit the camera. All right, so we got a little manual here, which is cool. We have all these cables. This power supply is modular, so you can use these or not use these. I'm going to be using at least three of them. One for the board, and then one for the graphics card. And I think one other one goes on the board, I think, too. So let's see what we got. We have some screws. And this is, let's see if we can get that centered. This is, see now if I was Marcus Brownlee, I'd be happy because all this is matte black. Let's see, is there anything else? Just some desiccant and some screws? Okay, we're good. Okay, we're just gonna pop that down here on the floor. Everything goes on the floor. Okay. Let's see, let's check the chat. That's how you cleaned up in the last CPU build. That is how I cleaned up in the last CPU build. I just tossed it and it ended up somewhere. So here's the power supply here. This is the EVGA650 and we're going to pop that into the case, and I'm just going to show you that case in just a moment. But this is really cool. It's got the switches and all that. It's got this the eco button here, which I'm not sure exactly what that is. I don't think anyone knows what that does. If you know what the eco button does, I know it has something to do with the ecological. No. So it's got some cool stuff on here. It says supernova, which I don't think that means anything. I'm just going to put this right here and grab the case. Let's grab that case. I said that as if I'm going to cut to grabbing the case. Oh my goodness. I might actually need some help from my helper. I need help from my helper. Ahem. I don't have a helper anymore. Okay, so I'm just gonna grab it. Bear with me, because I may not be wearing pants. Okay. Let's grab this here. Okay.
Oh.
All right. So the overhead cam is ill-equipped to show this humongous case, which I may also be ill-equipped to show it. Let's see. Okay. Don't want to drop the motherboard off of here. So let's just move this over here. All right. That was a bit scary. Okay. So yes, Jordan, yes, it was definitely signs. It was definitely signs. I think it was the last words the Mel Gibson's wife told him was to tell her brother, maybe brother-in-law, his brother, I don't know, tell Joaquin Phoenix's character to swing away. So it was supposed to all kind of work together and make some kind of cohesive destiny thing. Anyway, this is an NZXT case here, and I don't know if you can see what that looks like. I'm just going to hold it up because I don't think the overhead camera is really going to be able to see it. So that's the case here. It's pretty much pretty standard case. There's not a whole bunch of vents and things like that. It does have space for a fan inside here, inside the case there. And then it's got ventilation on the side here, which you can probably see. Yeah, ventilation here along the side. Now, it doesn't have ventilation on the front. It's got a fan on top here, and that's about it, which is kind of a bummer, mainly because I got that liquid cooling, which comes with these two fans. So I'm going to have to put those two fans right up front. And this is closed. I wonder if this comes off. It does not. It does not come off. Okay. So it's very possible I could have gotten the wrong case because it doesn't have ventilation. My case has opening up front for fans, and I don't have any extra fans. This one does not have opening for fans, but has three extra fans. So we're going to have to make that work because that's what we bought and that's what I ordered and that's what came in. So let's open her up here. This is the back portion. I'm just going to open this up. Unscrew that. Let's see, that comes right off. And we're just going to put that in the parts graveyard down there. All right, so we have the back, basically the back of the case. We have our little handy-dandy box of screws and things. Fun fact, the last time I did the build on the last video, it took me forever to figure out why this was in the hard drive slot. I couldn't get it out. There are two little clips that you need to pinch and pull. I was doing this way. So I was basically pushing on the pull door at the short bus school. That doesn't make any sense. at the school. Oh my goodness. It is a long night. I'm not even going to keep trying to be funny. So let's do this. We have all of our wires here. They go to our motherboard. We have, I think that's the hard drive light, and this is, it goes directly to the board for power. Let's see, we got some other stuff. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and take this back out and see what's in here. I think it's just the screws for the motherboard, if I'm not mistaken, and a few more cables. Yes, there's a cable in there, on a little headphone jack, a little headphone adapter. That's cool. Nice. And the cables are labeled. Isn't that nice? The last PC build that I did, the cables weren't labeled. and they didn't even correspond to what I had. So the motherboard and the case had cables that had little, the pins, I just had to basically figure out what the pins, you know, where the pins went. It was extremely tedious and took forever. And yeah, anyway, past is past. Let's go forward. What do we got? I remember that. I remember that aha moment. Yeah. let's see. Oh, that's all we had. So who's, how many people we got watching? We have just about three people watching. That's fine. That's fine. It's late. It's 11:45. I mean, I could have done this earlier and got a whole lot more viewers, but I think this is nice. It's just you and me, and we're just hanging out, talking about random stuff and you know, building computers. So yeah, if you have anything in the chat that you want to talk about, let it rip. Again, I do comics, and if you don't know, I'm working on a project called Veil of Night. And Veil of Night is a story about a character named Vic, and she is someone that is in the world that deals in magic. And essentially, it's a fantasy story where she has to learn how to use a newfound power that's been deep within her this whole time, and figure out how to use that power to stop an evil witch that is trying to destroy everything, basically. Actually, she's not necessarily trying to destroy everything, but if she succeeds in her plan, she would definitely destroy everything. So, spoiler, no, I'm kidding. If you want to talk about that, that's fine. I'll give you any answers that you would like. Aside from anything that would be too spoilery, if you want to know more about the characters and things like that, the world, and that kind of thing, definitely let me know. But in the meantime, I'm actually going to be building this computer. If you have any questions about the computer, you can ask that as well, and I will answer those to the best of my ability. So, let's get moving. All right, we need to put the power supply into the case. So let's just go ahead and do that. Let's see. So what cables do we need? We probably want to hook up the cables before slapping it in there. So we have motherboard. We need to get those added. So let's add the motherboard cable. Let's see. We got SATA cables. We got VGA, EVGA. We want to keep that off to the side. Here we are. Motherboard. There we are. So we're just going to put, we're going to unwrap this here and just pop this into the slot there for the motherboard. So I'm just going to open this up. And yeah, so we have the big one on this side that's going to go to the motherboard, and then this one here is going to go to the actual power supply unit. Hence, PSU. That's what it says on there. It says PSU. Oh, you know what? I can probably slide this over so you can see what I'm doing. Guess that would be nice. You are here to hang out and watch me build a computer. At least that's what I think you're here for. You could just be here to see if I'm going to break it, which is totally fine too. And that seems fair to me. So I'm just going to pop these cables in here. I don't know if you can see that. The camera is a little bit on. There we go. I'm just going to pop these right here. Just going to pop this one here. I say pop a lot, so I apologize. Pop. Pop, pop. Anybody that watch Community? Let's see what we got. See, Jordan says, Erie here on the West Coast. Oh, early here on the West Coast. Gotcha. Yeah. And then, any spoilers for the Veil of Night? Yeah, no spoilers. But if you ask me specific questions, I can let you know whether or not I can answer those. Let's see. Yeah, bro, I follow Jimmy's stream and in Discord. Awesome. Cool. And computer question. is less expensive building it yourself. Okay, so you would, it really depends. It's not necessarily less expensive to build it yourself, unless you're building it, when you buy the computer, you're buying all the parts and having somebody else build it, because the person is gonna, it's just like a car dealership, a situation where even though they're gonna be building the computer for you, you still gotta buy the parts. So you're gonna be adding parts along with labor in order to build a computer. So it might be cheaper to go that route, to build it yourself and just kind of learn how to do it as you go. There's tons of YouTube videos out there. I've watched pretty much all of them, if that's possible. Specifically, like Linus, I want to say tech news, anyway, Linus, if you just type in Linus tech, it'll come up. It'll probably be the first video to come up. They got hundreds and millions of thousands of whatever, kajillions of followers, subscribers and things like that. So they do this all the time. They actually had, not too long ago, they did a live stream where they had a speed build to see how many he can build in a certain amount of time. And he got it down to 30 minutes. Like, I think it was less than that, actually. I think by the end of the show, by the end of the stream, I think he got it down to where he was doing a speed build in about 20 or something like that. It was nuts. And when I saw that, I realized that all the things that I was doing in my last video in regards to building a computer, I was just kind of doing it wrong, basically. Cable management was something that I really didn't even think about, to be honest. And also, as I was putting everything together, I put it all together in like kind of basically a random order that didn't make sense. I didn't handle the motherboard until after I got everything going on in the case. It was just weird because I didn't really know what I'm doing. I still don't really know what I'm doing, but this is fun. I actually like doing this. So I may do this more if someone asks me to do a computer, a comic book bomb. If you have a computer that you want me to build, just let me know. Send me the parts or send me the money to buy the parts, and I'll build a computer and send it to you. Again, this isn't a tech channel. This is we're doing art, but, this is just something fun that I figured I'd do, because I have to do it anyway. This is something that I wanted to get done, and, I'm actually talking more than actually I'm doing. So I need to get that taken care of. So, basically I wanted to make sure that I got this computer built by a certain date because we're going to be using it on Wednesday. So I have to get this built, and not just built, but I also have to get all of the software added to it, which is probably the thing that's going to take the longest in order to get this up and running for Wednesday, for our Wednesday service. So the next thing is, these are SATA cables. I need the CPU cable. SATA CPU. Here we go. Awesome. All right, we're going to toss the CPU cable on here, and then we're going to put, since we're not using any SATA drives, we're just going to put the VGA cable in, and then we can just pop this power supply in, and then we're good to go. So we have, this says GA, this CPU. Okay. This goes here. Like that. Boop. All right. So we have that set up. We have that on there. We need to, VGA cable. Let's put the VGA cable in. We have that. Now we have two VGA cables, just in case you have two graphics cards. Let's see. Maybe I should play some music or something. Put some music in the background. This is like silent. let's see. No apologies necessary. Did I apologize? I think I did. I probably did. I tend to apologize. Sorry. No. let's see. Yeah, I built a couple of my own over a decade ago. Yeah, and see, like, it's so different from back then to now. Now, everything is, I mean, obviously we didn't have like modular power supplies, and generally when you bought a case, the case came with a power supply. It was already in there. So yeah, everything is different now. And I feel bad. I feel old. I really do. But this is the kind of thing that pushes you out of your comfort zone. so you can stay relevant. So you learn this stuff by doing this stuff. Excuse me. That was not a COVID cough. So, yeah, that wasn't COVID cough. Let's see. Oh, no, I said the C word. Let's see. Let's pop this in right there. I'm kind of off camera. I'm not center. I just realized I'm not center. I am so sorry. So, let's see. We got that. I think that's all we needed. Or do we hook up this side? Let's grab the manual. Let's click. Let's go here. Let's go here. Now we're doing a Henry Cavill impersonation. So we're just going to look through here. I'm pretty sure that that is the correct way. Yeah. Yeah, that should be fine. All right, cool. So that's connected, that's connected, that's connected. All right, let's go ahead and screw this bad boy in to the case here. And I don't want to break anything. There we go. All right. So let's move you over. My table is not big enough for this. All right. So the NZXT case. These spots here are for drives. You can have the small drives that you can buy now, or the SSD, the larger SSD. You can put those there. I won't be using any of those, nor am I going to use the drive bay down here. Here, I'm not going to be using this drive bay either, because we don't have any drives that will fit that right now. We're just going to use just the small SSD, the M.2, mainly because we don't need any internal storage, because everything that we're going to be doing is going to be saved to not the cloud, but it's going to be saved to Google Drive. And so all of our services, when we go back to having regular services in-house, what we'll do is we will still stream, but those videos get recorded and the audio also gets recorded separately through vMix and added to and uploaded to the Google Drive. And when that happens, we can go back and reference them. We can go back and repost them if we need to. We can make them into DVDs or CDs or whatever the case is, with some pretty good audio. Hopefully pretty good audio and video. So by the end of this, what I plan to do is have 1080p video going into this computer and streaming over YouTube at least around 720. I want to see if I can get it to 1080 streaming on YouTube, but I don't know if they stream live on YouTube for 1080, and I don't even know if I'm at 1080 on here. Probably am not. See what we got in the chat. What do we say here? It's fun for me also. Been using. Okay, so Jordan says it's fun for me also. It's been using my Big Mac for last 8 years. Might need upgrade someday. So crazy thing, I actually have a Mac as well. I have a large Mac Pro, the cheese grater. It's over here in the corner on the floor. I have the Mac Pro over here on this side, which is silver, and then I have a black PC that I built for the PC build that I did, and they're both on here. I realized that they're both hooked up to this monitor, hooked up to the keyboard and all that stuff. I can switch between the two of them, but I haven't been switching. I've just been staying with PC, and I've been with Mac for I don't know. For a long time now, because I had one of the first Mac Minis, then I went from Mac Mini to another Mac Mini, actually, and then from that Mac Mini to, I think, to this one. Yeah, so it went from Mac Mini to Mac Pro, and then from Mac Pro to PC, mainly because I kept, it just was super slow, and I couldn't do anything to speed it up. I tried erasing all this stuff off the hard drive. I tried optimizing it, doing all the things that they say on YouTube to do to try to get it to run faster. And it just didn't work for me. And I love Mac. I really do. The stability of the system, the fact that everything just kind of works when you are on it, I love it. And it let me down. Or maybe I let it down. I don't know. The whole thing is it didn't work when I needed it to work. And I got really frustrated and I really wanted to get some stuff done on it. I can't really blame it, mainly because of the fact that I bought it. I bought it on eBay. And yeah, I know. I know, before you say it, it was a custom built Mac, and it had everything I wanted in there. It had all the software that I wanted in there, and it was only like maybe $780, $800 or something like that. It was custom built, and I didn't realize this, but about a year or a year and a half later, when I tried to upgrade the software, it was hard for me to upgrade the software because it had no serial number. In like it wasn't like programmed into the computer on the OS. It wasn't on there. It was on the chassis, but it wasn't on the actual OS in the actual computer. So I couldn't upgrade to the next thing up. Every time I tried to do anything, it basically said this isn't compatible. And in order for me to basically get the same level of performance that I get out of this PC, I would have had to pay like $3,700 or something even more astronomical than that. As a matter of fact, now that I think about it, I wouldn't have had, right now I have 12 cores. It's the AMD Ryzen 9 in that one. Also 500 gigabytes of storage. Plus I added a couple extra hard drives that I had from other PCs that I've had in the past and a couple laptop hard drives that were like 250 and 300. So those are all in there. And the graphics card and all that. Yeah, this thing is a beast. It really is. And I would have not been able to get anywhere near that with a Mac for the price. So I love Mac. I love Apple. Invested in Apple, probably. I think so. Got to check my stock portfolio. But when it comes down to it, I don't know, man. The PC, just for the price, is just, I don't know, bang for buck. That's what you got to go for, is that bang for buck. Let's see what he say. Blah, blah, blah. That's what we got. I said the C word. Oh, that's my last. Oh, C word. Yeah, it is your last name. That's funny. let's see. So awesome you getting live stream hooked up for your church. Yeah. Yeah, LMJ, I'm going to mess this up. It's just letters, and I'm still going to mess it up. Is it MJEV, or is it LMG, or LMJEV? Anyway, whoever it is, sup? MJEV. Okay, so I just see C. Jordan saying, hey, what's up? And it says, at MJEV, is lowercase. Okay, so MJEV, how's it going? Probably, I don't think I've seen that name. If I have... Please take my apology because I'm horrible with names. So if you're already somebody that I've met either online or in person, my bad. So okay, so let's get this done. I don't want to have this stream go like 5 and 6 hours because I do have to go to work in the morning. So let's do this. Where's it's over here. So we're gonna go ahead and grab our. I say go ahead a lot. I realize I did that. So I'm just going to slide this in like so. If you hear some scratching noises, pay no attention to that. Okay, so that's awesome. All right, so the screw holes actually line up this time. On mine, the screw holes actually lined up with the honeycomb pattern that's on the grate. So I end up screwing one of the screws into the honeycomb pattern. Again, I have no idea what I'm doing most of the time. And it was really like kind of frustrating building that last computer. So I really don't know why I'm doing it again, but you know, the things you do for your church, things to do for your faith, that kind of thing. So, all right, so let's put this together. Let's get the screwdriver here. I think that's the right one. Yep, that works. And then the screws, which we just grabbed from over here. Nope, this is the screw for it. This is for the motherboard. Where are the screws for the water supply? The power supply screws. Or are they? Please don't get offended. I don't think that was an accent on purpose. That was just a funny voice. So if there is an accent out there that mimics what it, or that I mimicked by accident, my apologies. So, let's see. I don't know what the screws are. Let's see. It's funny because I know I just had them a second ago. Let's see. Are these? No. Weird. Okay. Oh, they're still in the box. They're literally taped to the box. So slow. And I'm getting a notification on my phone. What does it say? Who is this? Oh, someone just subscribed. Oh, cool. So this is like real time. I can, XXEliminate-YT. You just got a shout out because you just became a new subscriber on my live stream, or live. So figured I will give you a shout out. Thanks for the sub. Definitely appreciate that. Hopefully it's not just for the tech stuff because it's not really a tech channel. but look, hey, we can move things around. If we can somehow incorporate comic book art and tech at the same time, that would be dope. Oh. Oh yeah, because I miss PCs. Yeah, definitely. MJev, oh, LM Jev, and it's Leon. Oh, okay. Wait, Leon? Leon who? Let's see. I probably messed it up too. I'm forgetting names all the time. So it's okay. Oh, okay, cool. I'm glad you all patched that up. So, all right, let's move on. All right, I got my screwdriver, and let's pop this in here. Pop. All right. And of course, the first thing I do is drop the screw onto the floor. No. Where'd it go? Found it. Okay. So, smarter thing would be to move this a little bit further away from the edge of the table. For two reasons. One, it will be on camera. Sorry, I hit the camera. The camera's actually pretty close. One, it'll be on the camera. And two, it will... the screws won't fall off the doggone on the floor here. So I'm just going to hand tighten these first screws in, which is probably the smarter way to do this. This is so... Oh, Kemp, as in your nephew. Leon... Why are you even up? It's midnight. I guess you don't have school, so I guess it doesn't matter. It's past midnight. So yeah, for those who are wondering who LM Jev is, LM Jev is actually my nephew, Leon. So you can probably see it in the chat. He's already said that. You need to identify yourself more clearly next time, then give you a proper shout out. Shout out? Shout out. Where's the other screw? Oh, just that quick. All right, last screw. Let's put that in. Does anybody out there watch, or used to watch, Community? It's one of my favorite shows. I can still watch that at any given time. Quote it all the time. That's where the pop comes from. It's from Magnitude. Community. I don't go to sleep till the morning. You're gonna have to get out of that habit, brother. Mainly because, you know, eventually you'll have school. Eventually. I don't know when. With the global pandemic and all that. Who knows, you may never go back to school. It may turn into Mad Max, Fury Road. You may be schooled by someone in a sand hut and while chewing on a femur from your previous victim. That went dark. Yeah, I know. That went dark. Dr. Ken. Oh, yeah. Wait. I missed a few chats. I don't go to sleep in the morning. Me too. I watch Community at your house. Yes, I know. Let's see. Oh, with Dr. Ken. Yeah. With Dr. Ken. And see, I knew him first from The Hangover. And then... Community, and then I think he got his own show, Dr. Ken, where he kind of mixed comedy, and he is a certified doctor. He's got some certifications in something, but he's a doctor. He has his doctorate. He's a practice doctor. What is that even called? He's a licensed physician. There it is. He's a licensed physician. And it's really cool that he just decided, I'm going to be an actor. That's pretty dope. So that's kind of something that's under his belt. Let's see. What I'm looking through these these cables and screws that came with the motherboard. All right, so our power supply is in. We have all these wires hanging out. So we're going to have to start dealing with cable management because last time I didn't. And it looked atrocious back here. Like my computer, you take that back plate off and it looks like a rat's nest back there. So I want this one to look a lot better because we may need to open it up to add or remove things later on. So we want to do that. And so we want to do that. Let's see. Certifiable. Yeah. He's definitely certifiable. He's funny. I don't like his stand-up though. So, what's this? Ken Jeong? Ken Jeong, I think is his name. Dr. Ken, or just Ken. Just Ken if you're nasty. I don't know where that came from. I'm tired. Ken is, I watched this stand-up and it wasn't that funny. I kind of like him more in things like, like The Hangover. He was hilarious in The Hangover. I think he was in part two, I want to say. And then I didn't see part three, if there was a part three. I think there was a part three. And then also in Community. So he's just crazy in Community, and it's hilarious. So yeah, that's the show that I really kind of I love that show. Anyway. Tangent. All right, let's move some of these cables around so we we have the power supply in. I have to focus. I have to always keep reminding myself what I'm doing. I have to focus here. So we have this here. So, okay, let's turn this around. Let's go ahead and put the motherboard on and screw that in. And then we can kind of go from there. We'll just turn this around this way. Turn the case around. Get the motherboard in. Turn it upside down. Let's see. Why is this not? Am I doing something wrong here? I'm afraid to touch it because it's the tempered glass. Is it literally only held in by one screw? That can't be the case. I mean, this is the case, but that can't be. Oh, it says pull this way. Aha. All right. Hi. So, I was a bit nerve-wracking. I didn't want to break that. It is tempered glass. And I almost lost my light there. Let me not. Oh, no, I lost my light. I lost my light. Haziz light. All right. Let's try to get my light back on. What do we have to do to get my light back on? Okay. Awesome. All right. Light's back. Thank you, Haziz. Okay. So we have the case and I'm looking through the case. It's nice framing, huh? So now, of course, it doesn't look very good on the overhead cam. Let's just grab this, put it down here so we can see what we're doing. All right. Focus, focus. All right. So this is the inside of the case. We're going to go ahead and drop the motherboard in there, and we're going to screw these down onto the screw posts. Where's our motherboard? Oh, back here. Yeah, there we are. So we're just going to grab the motherboard, try not to touch too many of these contacts here. You're going to see my horribly misshapen body. Let's see. This goes this way. Yeah, it's going to go this way. Let's put this over here. Just drop that in. Way too much scraping for my taste. Again, I'm not like the best at this. All right, let's see. This should kind of seat down in there. There we go. All right, because there's a little pin right here. I don't know if you can see that on the camera. There's a pin right here that keeps it in place. And now it's lined up. All the screw holes are lined up. So we're just going to go toss those screws in. And maybe I might zoom in a bit. Let's see if I can zoom in and check. Oh, you know what? We can go to the other camera here. I haven't been switching between cameras. There we go. All right. It's going to center that. All right. So there's a screw post, or there's a post right here that actually keeps the motherboard in place. And let's see. I'm just reading the, getting caught up on the chat here. Chow for hangover. Yes, I used to refer to his as a. Oh, I used to refer to him as that. Yeah. let's see. And then, yeah, I love community and framing. It's like a comic book panel. Yeah, it is. See, it is like a comic book. See, it does relate. It does relate to the channel. It's just like a comic book channel or comic book panel. All right. So, so we have all of the stuff in. We have our memory in. We have our CPU, our processor in here with the Ryzen 7. And then we have the Samsung Evo Plus. It's a 250. And then we have the motherboard in place. Now, the thing we want to do is we want to screw the motherboard down, but we need to find out where all these cables are as well, because we need to start thinking about adding the cables to the spots where they need to go, like this one here. This is from the power supply, and then a few other spots are going to have some cables connected to it. So the color is a bit off, but that's fine. It's not quite the same as as my camera here because I'm have a Canon here, which is fine. It's totally fine. It looks blurry on that screen though, but it's clear here. Anyway, let's see. Yeah. So just checking the chat, and so I'm gonna look down here. I think it would be a good idea to go ahead and screw down the motherboard before we move it around too much, because I'm clumsy. I'm the kind of person I would move it around and then all of a sudden the motherboard comes flying out of it. Let's do that first. Let's find the right screw. So this comes, the chassis actually comes with multiple screws, multiple sets of screws, like this little baggie of screws here, and then this little baggie of screws here, and then this little baggie of screws here, and then lastly, what is this? A baggie of screws. All right, so all of these don't all go in here. The cool thing about buying a buying these computer parts in pieces is the fact that they give you, you know, screws that could possibly fit pretty much any one of your pieces that you buy. So let's grab the ones that fit. That's not those. I think it's these. Yeah, I believe so. Let's check. We can always just grab one, pop it in. It looks like it fits. Keep going. That might be a little small. I think that's a little too small. Let's grab these. So I'm just gonna try that. See if that one works. So I'm drop it on there. And I don't wanna move it too much. So I'm sure like some of you computer guys who work on computers all the time, probably like cringing because of the fact that I'm not using a static bracelet or you know, gloves or even a static mat, and like I'm basically like moving metal around metal, causing charges without I think it's this one without a care at all in the world. And you're right, I probably should be wearing all that, and I think I even bought that. No, that's way too small. I think I even bought that, but I am being super lazy right now. I really don't feel like grabbing all that and putting it on. Should be fine. Should be. Let's go back to this one. I think that's the right screw, so I'm gonna screw that in. And if it fits, we're gonna keep moving. Yeah, there we go. All right, so these are the screws. All right, so we got one screw in. I'm gonna put like one more screw in, and then before I screw the rest of the motherboard in, I'm gonna go ahead and start dealing with these cables and connecting the motherboard to the power supply, as well as to anything else that needs to be connected, like the actual chassis itself. Because I wanna make sure that those wires can move, and if I need to unscrew the motherboard and reposition it, reposition it, then I want to be able to not have to take out 16 screws. Well, it's not 16, it's probably just like 9. Take out like 9 screws and every time, or you know, after I just put them in. Come on, get in there. Oh, you know what? I don't think I'm even on camera. I think my hand is covering it. Let's see. Yep. It's a little angle, slight angle. All right, so we got 2 screws in there. We have one on this side and one on this side. So the motherboard is fairly stable. It's got the little post in the middle here that keeps the motherboard from sliding around. So now we can kind of move we can move the computer around, or move the whole thing around. See all the stuff I'm rolling over. We can move the computer around without fear of losing the motherboard or dropping it. So what I'm going to do is turn it back over and run the cables up and through and figure out exactly where everything needs to go in order to go onto the motherboard. So let's do that now. Hopefully I don't have anything that's moving. Oh, that's my cable. Oh. All right. So we're back on the back. Back on the back. All right. We have, what is this? What is that? I thought that was like a SATA cable or something, but that is not what I thought it was. I'm just going to reconnect that and keep that there. Poke that in through. Okay, so here we want to make sure that this cable here goes into the motherboard. There is definitely a spot for this cable on the motherboard, and we're just going to run that through. So we're, because it's coming from this angle, we're going to go ahead and keep it on that angle. I think it's on this side. Usually that connector connects. I think this is all the hard, oh, long one. I think it's the hard drive cable. I'm not sure which cable that is. I'm not smart enough to know, and I probably should have done some research beforehand. So we have the HD audio cable cable here. We have the F panel here. So we're just going to go ahead and run those through and connect those to their corresponding spots on the other side of the case. And while we're at it, we're going to go ahead and slide the whatever this cable is cable. I think this is the hard drive light, or is this the hard drive light? One of these is the hard drive light. I don't want to pull that out because it looks like it's nice and neat in there, but I don't think it's going to fit if it stays over there. Let's pull that out. Come on out of there. All right, so this is, it says AYT. I'm not sure exactly what that is. All right, so we're gonna just run this through here. That sounded about right. And then this one, because it was too short, to go all the way across here. There's some spots down below here that I'm just gonna run it down there. And you can't see that. So I'm going to put it through here to connect to the board. Okay, so now we have that through here. This is for the graphics card. So we're going to pull that through. So our graphics card is actually going to be over here. So we're just going to run that down here. Oh, can you see it? Yeah. Actually, I wish I probably would have run that through before. That's not gonna fit. So let's just run it through here. Just gonna run it through there. Make it work. Make it work. Make it work. All right, that's through there. Now we need the motherboard cable. This is CPU, so we need the CPU cable. CPU cable is going to connect to the CPU. I think it's up at the top here. So we're going to run this. We're going to Velcro this here and then run it across the top because I believe it connects right up here in the corner. And I don't want this to, there we go. So that will run along there. That's nice and neat. That will run straight back there. That's nice and neat. And where's my, there we are. Yeah, this one is the one I'm looking for, the big granddaddy. All right, so this one here is going to, where does it connect? Is it on this side? Yep, it's on this side. All right, so this is gonna go straight through here. I like it a lot. Okay, so that's gonna go through there. That's all connected to Do we have any stray wires? I don't think we have any stray wires. All right, so all of our cables that we need to connect from power supply and the chassis are run through to their respective spots. And so we're gonna flip it back over and then get those connected to the motherboard. Let's do that now. And hopefully none of the cables fall back out. All right. All right, we don't wanna pull on them too much. And we don't want them to really kind of rub against the motherboard here. So I'm just going to tuck away the ones that we're not going to work with right now. Let's tuck that back. Okay, so first one we want to connect is this big boy right here, which I'm noticing that the color is not that great. I don't know if you can see. Maybe I should bring up the exposure. Let me see. I'm going to see if I can get more color here. Yeah, that's a great view of the guts. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I need to get something on that. Let's see. Is this a replacement for the current live streaming computer? Yes, yes. It's going to replace the current live stream on the left side. So you've been gone for a while, Leon. And so what we did some reconfiguring of the sound at the sound booth at the church. And we also did, we reconfigured some of the monitors and things like that. But we got some funding that will allow us to basically get a new computer so we can get the streaming going, and also to get some other equipment that we really sorely needed to get everything up and running. So that's basically what I've been doing, is just kind of, because everything is now live streaming when it comes to all the church services, Pastor wants to have a increased focus on our live streaming technology ministry, basically. So he wants to make sure that everything works, everything is reliable, everything is, you know, doing its thing the way it's supposed to, without basically logging on to the site and seeing that there's no sound, or the sound is bad, or the video is bad, or whatever the case is. We're basically trying to mitigate all of that. So I am seeing a potential problem here. This cable does not want to bend to my will. So let's pull it out this way. And just bring it this way. And that should help with getting that in. Is that even the right way? Is that the right way? Ah, it's the wrong way. Okay. So I need to turn it. Oh my goodness. I promise that's not COVID. Oh, there's a little median right there. That's why. All right, so this is actually gonna fold back on itself. Should I go from the bottom? Maybe? Is that what it is? Just kinda need to go at a different angle? Yeah, I think that's what it was. Let's move that. Is that on? Is that in? I can't tell. No, it's not all the way in. It doesn't. I didn't hear a snap. I don't want to snap the motherboard, so I'm pressing this down on here. I think it's... Yeah, it's good. Okay. All right, so the cables are through. Oop. I already took the glass off, so we're good. The cables are through. And you know what? I'm going to go ahead and put the rest of the screws into the motherboard to keep that down, because I just noticed that when I push this down, this is kind of moving around and it's only got the two screws in. I don't want to crack the motherboard. So people watching, if you know anything about building computers, you're probably looking at me like, you are an idiot. You should have screwed in all the screws first for many reasons. And then they push up their glasses like this. Actually, or if it's an anime, they have the light hitting. Let's see if I can get a glare. There it is. Actually, you should have added all the screws because of whatever reason. Are these even the right? Nope, they're not the right screws. Come on. All right. They're over here. Of course, they're over here. The right screws are here. And that's why I went to this view, mainly because it puts my humongous belly, get in my belly, puts my humongous belly on the small screen. So we can keep it like this for a while. I'm going to be working inside the chassis for this period of time anyway. Wait, why is that not screwing in? Well, that's weird. Those two screwed in, but these didn't. Okay. It's because I grabbed more of the same screw, that's why. Yeah, it's these over here, sorry. Yeah, this is definitely, in case you didn't know, this is definitely not a tutorial. Let's see. Let's go back to the chat. What does it say? That's a great view of the cuts. Yeah. Let's see. Is it replacement for the? Yeah, we already answered that. That's good. Yeah, that is good. That live stream capability is great for when things go back to normal. Yeah. And there will actually. And there are actually actual attendees. Excuse me, live stream is great for people who can't get out. Yeah, see, and that was the thing. Our church, we live stream every service. We live stream even before COVID was a thing, and well, you know, apparently, COVID is definitely something that's been around for years and years and years and years. Anyway, I'm not gonna get into that. So. Yeah, we live stream every service, and when this all kind of started, the problem wasn't necessarily that the problem was the fact that our streaming wasn't really up to par. It really wasn't, and I take full responsibility for that, mainly because of the fact that it wasn't when we went into the church, we were more focused on the people and the sound that we were getting inside the church. And even though we did have live streaming capabilities and we were doing that, it wasn't very reliable, and it didn't always work how we wanted it to, mainly because we had a lot of things that were kind of jury-rigged, and a lot of things that were connected improperly, and a lot of redundant things that we thought we needed and some stuff like that. And after really assessing, when streaming became a focus, like a main focus, because obviously nobody's really going into the actual church building anymore. They're just going online. And if your video goes out, or if your sound goes out, or if the video is blurry, or the sound is muffled, or anything like that, then people just tune off or tune out. Tune out. Yeah, they just change to another YouTube channel, or go somewhere else to get their Sunday sermon, or get be fed, basically spiritually fed. So we want to make sure that we stay viable in what's been going on, and make sure that we are optimized for the best possible stream we can have. And that's essentially what we're trying to do, is make sure that all of our equipment is up to par, and all of the people that use the equipment are trained on what we are using. So we have someone that generally, primarily does sound, and he takes care of the sound in-house. And he also is the person that's in charge of making sure that we have microphones and speakers and things like that when we go away from the church. Like, so we have two different locations. And basically what they do is sometimes they'll have service at the other location, and he will bring microphones and all kinds of other things that he would need. That did not, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, man, that fell right through there, too. Okay, so, oh, awesome. It fell right through. Awesome. But he makes sure that the camera, or not the camera, but the microphones and everything are good, and also that the sound is good for the soundboard in-house and at the other location. And I make sure that the sound and video is good for partially in-house, but also for the streaming. So, because streaming is the focus right now, it kind of took priority. So even if the sound in-house isn't that great or is kind of lacking at the moment, Pastor basically said, hey, this right here is the focus. We need to get, you know, the live stream up and running, you know, get this taken care of. We need to get this taken care of. So this is why we are putting together this computer. Now, why am I putting it together on my YouTube channel? That's a totally different story. That, in and of itself, let's see, wait. That live stream capability is great for, definitely. Let's see, most of the time when I see people build computers, they always say they never really, they never really put every screw, but like two diagonally. Yeah, yeah. And see, that's that's what I would have done. And I put them across from each other, not realizing that I probably should have put them diagonally to keep one side in, the other side in. Because if you ever have to, if you have to pull it back out, then you have to pull all these screws out. But I just realized when I was pressing this cable down on here that it felt like the board was kind of bowing a bit, and I didn't like that. So I decided to. And even now, even with a few more screws in there, this cable is, it just didn't want to go all, it doesn't really feel like it's going all the way in, and I don't want to force it, because when it comes to computers and computer parts, you don't want to force anything because of the fact that things break, and it's really scary, so... So yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. I'm basically just kind of, I want this to seat all the way in, and I'm not getting that leverage on this cable like I want. I think that's what it is. I know it's in the right way. It's just not snapping. Come on. Don't want to force it in there. Like, if I pull on this... Oh, maybe... Oh, okay, it's fine. Okay, it's fine. Yeah. All right, so where was I? I can't remember. Anyway, it doesn't matter. So, yeah, we just basically want to make sure that we have the computer and everything hooked up and ready for service, with all the right software and all that. I think this goes here. In almost every case, when you're putting together a computer, and I say this as I'm trying to force in a cable, most, if not all cables, really only go in one slot. The pin configuration and the little peg that keeps them from going in the wrong slot, and I am not liking the color of this, basically keeps it from where you can't really put them in the wrong space. But then comes Joe. So it's very possible that I could be putting them in the wrong space. Let's see. I'm going to, I really want to adjust the color of, I'm going to adjust the color of this video, of this camera here. I think I can do it while I'm working on it. Let's see. Properties. Oh no. Okay, I think I'm back. I apologize about that. Yeah, I went to the properties to adjust the camera that's right here, and it shut down OBS altogether. So I don't know what that was about. Let's see. What program are you live streaming program? I'm live streaming from, I'm using OBS, and I would use vMix, but I don't have that on my personal computer, but we have that at the church. I'm using OBS. I apologize. I did cut out the live stream for just a moment. That was totally unintentional. And basically what happened was, the video, I was trying to adjust the color on this video. And when I did that, it made, OBS just shut down. So I'm just checking the stream. I'm looking at the stream health, and looks like we have 5 viewers. Wow. That's like 5 more than I expected to have. So, all right, let's get back to this. We are back up and running. I just wanted to make sure that I am still streaming on the stream here. Oh, it's way behind. Let's see if I can get this back to live. Let's see.
Oh, it's way behind.
Oh, I'm good. All right. I just have to check it. Okay. So back to streaming. Yeah. We're super professional around here. Super professional. All right. So we're going to just go ahead and hook up this cable here to the right spot here. And we're just going to make sure it goes in the right thing. Just going to push that down in there. All right, so that is connected. I'm not sure exactly what that is, but I know it connects there. Then we have F panel. The F panel is, was that front panel probably? Or let's see, where does that go? We have JFP1 over here. And then we have JUSB. System fan. So we have J audio. Okay, so that's audio. So that's this one. I think that one's only got 3 holes. Okay, so it's one of those situations where you would definitely consult the manual. So with CPU fan. What is that? JFP1, USB, USB, fan, TPM, COM, LPT, audio one. Where is my power? All right, so let's go to the handy dandy notebook. For all my old people that remember Blue's Clues. I gotta remember where I put that. And see, not only is cable management an issue for me, but manual management is an issue for me. Where did I put the manual? Oh, yuck. Yuck. Where is the manual for this thing? Let's see. I think it's down here on the floor. MSI. Oh, here it is. Or, nope, that is the CD. That is the CD. So, I have once again misplaced something that was probably important. Let's see. This is for the fan, MSI quick install. Ah, found it. I was looking for a book and it was actually the, it's a little step-by-step guide, which is actually better for me because it's visual. You know, who wants to read a book? Ugh. Let's see, we got Power SW, HDD LED, all that cool stuff. So that's stuff that goes here. Power LED. It says quick install, but you know, I don't think I've ever done anything quick. Power supply, bam, bam, bam. That's the plate. Actually, I should have put the plate on before I put the this back piece on. Let's see, that's SSD. JFP1 is the one for the hard drive light, the reset, and the power buttons. Okay, cool. So JFP1 is TPM, system fan, USB, USB 2, JFP1. It's over here in the corner. All the way over here in the corner. Let's move these out of the way. What is going on here? Can I open the bottom? No. All right, so let's lift it up. We're gonna pull this cable out because this is in the wrong place. And again, the last time I built this, built a computer for YouTube, I literally, okay, we don't have to take this out. I literally, I spent a long time just trying to figure out, like, when I connected a cable and then I tried to connect a different cable, it wouldn't fit because I connected the other cable first, and then I had to try to get around it, and I spent a lot of time trying to not disconnect that cable that I just connected, mainly because it's one of those things where, like, once you get something fixed or finished, you don't want to have to go back to it. Same thing what we were talking about earlier with the motherboard. Once you get it screwed in, you don't want to have to go back and unscrew it. So it's like, ugh. So, let's see. What is this? What is this? I actually don't know. It's not marked. I got a fever. I need more cowbell. Let's see. HD audio. That's crazy talk. This HD audio cable, the HD audio is all the way over here. That's not gonna reach. Back to the drawing board. Ow. I just smashed my finger, that hurt. Okay, so it doesn't look like I can do it the way I thought I was gonna do it. So we're just going to unrun. We're just going to pull these cables out. The ones that are not connected, we're just going to pull those out. I think this one still goes up at the top, so I'm going to leave that there. So I don't think that one goes anywhere else. But this one definitely needs to come out from under here and find a home. This one, let me see. I'm just reading the comments here. Let's see. I think stream kept going, but you lost your monitor. It was seamless. Oh, it was seamless. So you watched me. So you watched me like flounder and. That's funny. I did not know that. All right. So I need to. Good thing I didn't like pick my nose or anything. Let's see. Blah 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 blah. Make sure you're not on Top Chat. Top Chat. I'm not sure. It says live chat. It's pop out chat. Let me see. Pop out chat. It's probably best if I keep it up here. If I put it down here, maybe I can. No, I can't read it. It's way too small down there. Restore chat. Let's put that back where it came from. Let's see. So let's just go back down the chat. Let's see. We got cool. When I was live streaming, I used Streamlabs. Oh, this is Leon. Let's see. I use Streamlabs OBS because there is an app you can download on your phone to change scenes on the stream. It's pretty cool. Yeah. Elgato is a pretty good program for like the different like pre-recorded things, like the like scene transitions. But even if you want to have like a programmed like intro and outro and like graphics to go across the screen, I really need to get into that. I'm probably going to design most of that stuff later. If I ever do a live stream again, I'll definitely do that. Let's see. Leon, that sounds awesome. It was really cool to work with. Let's see. And it basically worked like Elgato Stream Deck. Yeah, which costs a lot of money. Yeah. So, yeah, I didn't read the last message before I started talking. Yeah, it's definitely... I have an Elgato... video capture card, which actually I'm not using right now because Canon just hooked us up with a driver that made it to where the video feed from the USB cable coming out of the Canon cameras can go directly into the computer in full HD. I'm like, why did I buy this video capture card if you're gonna give us to us for free? And I'm like, I felt like I wasted money, but I was super happy that I was able to just hook my camera up to the USB through the USB, and it just works. So weird. It just turns every Canon camera, every Canon DSLR camera into a webcam. Which actually, I don't know if it only works on a DSLR. It might work on other cameras that are through Canon, maybe like the Canon. Mark II or Canon 80D Mark II or whatever. Yeah. Anyway, one of those high grade cameras. I want to get that Canon R5, the EOS R5. Oh man, that looks so cool. If I had that, I would probably just have it on a shelf and it would sit there just like my T6i is sitting there. That's probably what's going to happen, mainly because of the fact that I need to get my butt into gear and start recording more YouTube videos. Yeah, that's the main thing. It's like I have a lot of equipment. I have, you know, nice lights and cameras and microphones and things like that, and I just want to keep upgrading to the next thing up, thinking that if I do that, if I just have the right microphone, if I have just the right lighting and the right camera, then I will commit to doing more YouTube videos. And that's not true. It's really just about your own commitment. There are people doing YouTube videos consistently on their cell phone. And they look good. They don't look bad at all. You know, they have them on a tripod. They have, you know, they stand in front of a window to have proper lighting, all that. And they look good. And I feel horrible that I don't post more often. And I have a lot of stuff. You know, I have, you know, all these, you know, lights and tripods. I just got a new tripod, actually. it's carbon fiber. Really, really cool. Anyway, so, yeah, I have all this stuff and I don't post nowhere near as much as I should. And mainly it's because content, man. I don't know what content to put out there. Hence this live stream of me building a computer. I'm literally just like doing some work that I just need to get done, and I just turned on the camera and started recording it. That's really all I did. It had nothing to do with, oh, you know what? I think my subscribers would actually like to watch me ham-fistedly kind of put together a computer and hope it works at the end of it. It's more like I needed to get this done, and it was a video that got a lot of views on my last the last PC build, and next thing I know, I'm live streaming it. My girlfriend was literally like, are you sure you want to live stream? You sure you just don't want to record it and then edit it? And then I realized, I don't feel like editing a 4-hour video, man. I don't feel like doing that. So in order to get content on the channel, I'm live streaming. So that's why I'm doing this today. I just lost my train of thought. Oh, okay. So I was moving the cables around. So yeah. All right. That was a tangent. Oh, no. I hit the overhead cam and I hit the microphone. Hopefully that didn't give too much noise. Let's see. In the chat, it says, really cool to work with, basic works, blah, blah, blah. I know it's the same thing happens to David Finch stream. He bumps it and loses monitor, but we don't go anywhere. Yeah, yeah. That actually, I watched David Finch a couple times where he thought he lost stream, and turns out he didn't. And other times where he totally lost stream at the very end. Like, I think last time I watched it, at the very end, it just shut off. And I was like, oh! He didn't come back on, so I guess he was just like, you know what? I was near the end anyway, so I might as well just go. There's no point in jumping back on the stream just to say bye, you know, that kind of thing. So I think he just put it in the chat down at the bottom, in the comments down at the bottom. He's like, he apologized for the stream cutting off abruptly. I know his son plays online, so I think that's what happened. He was streaming and he was just about to shut off, and I think his son got a little too anxious and decided to jump on his gaming platform and shut him down prematurely. But I have no idea what that household looks like. But Dave Finch is one of the coolest dudes that I've ever met virtually in regards to comics and stuff like that. He's really nice, and yeah, he's just a really cool guy, and he inspires me. He inspires Jimmy as well. Jimmy loves talking about David Finch and the covers and things like that and their friendship, and it's really cool. It's, you know, he's like a really genuine dude in regards to, like, Jimmy is a really genuine dude in regards to the fact that like he truly cherishes all of his friendships that he has with people. He calls people's names out on stream really cool in the sense of like all of his friends. Like, I try to mention my friends all the time. Like for instance, right now, Brian Atkins with Final Street plug. Let's see, Ben Sawyer with Butcher Queen, Planet of the Dead plug. Let's see, Anthony Fowler Jr. He is currently doing, actually, I think he's just doing inking studies, but he's an inker plug. Let's see. Somebody else is doing some stuff too. Jesse Quay is doing some stuff. I haven't really been up with what he's been doing lately. So I think he's still working on Samurai Cowboy. I'm sorry, Jesse. Send me a message. Let me know what to plug next time. I can't remember. I almost want to say Samurai Champloo, which is funny because that, I know it's not Cowboy Samurai or Samurai Cowboy. But he's a phenomenal artist as well as and I just realized what I said earlier makes it sound like I was saying something about the fact that Jimmy says his friends and that I didn't want that to come off that way. So let me recant that. I'm live, so this is definitely going to get back to me. Probably wasn't. I didn't mean it that way. I just thought about that after the fact. I'm like, did that come off? I think that came off a little weird. Anyway, yeah, Jimmy's awesome. Jimmy's awesome. And the fact that he found me on a live stream and like basically hired me on the spot to do Veil of Night, that was a dope situation. And I don't think I've ever had anything like that happen. Specifically in my art career, but for him to just be like, wow, I like your art, want a job? And I'm like, yeah. So that was sick. And Dave Philpott is awesome writer. It was really cool. And see, what's funny is Dave, his writing style is, I mean, not writing style, because I haven't read everything that he's written, but the stuff that he comes up with when we're talking and stuff like that, dude is a smart dude. Like, he's a smart guy, and I respect his opinion when it comes to story and things like that. So speaking of story, Veil of Night coming soon. Dragon Rage, already go to pageonecomics.com. I don't think I've actually even said Page One Comics this whole time I've been streaming. Oh, Jimmy's gonna kill me. So yeah, pageonecomics.com. Please go to the site, sign up for the mailing list for the newsletter. I think they just did an article on Bleeding Cool, so they're there. We're there. Yeah. Trying to remember to plug. But I forget. I'm sorry, guys. I'm really horrible at this. This is F panel, and I'm not sure exactly what F panel is. This is an adapter which goes to something and then connects to something else. So I probably need to look at that manual one more time, see what this adapter goes to. Because they correspond to the cable that I have out here. System fan. Right. I already found that. It's over there. Okay. But this is, I'm going to need that. So if PLED negative, PLED, oh, power to the LED, negative and positive, and then the power, power switch and hard drive light. Okay. Let's go back. Way back. Back into time. JFP1. And the order is hard drive light. And then reset switch, which is the power switch, same thing. And then so no pin goes there, that one's reserved. All right, so we just pop this in here. Can I get this in here? I'm not even on camera. Wow. Let's do that. So I'm working over here. You know what? Let's change that. Bing bong. Yeah, there we go. What is that? I know it's, wait, hold on. I gotta go back up, sorry. I know it's the same thing. Oh yeah, I've been wanting a video capture card so I can live stream my Xbox. That's what a lot of people do. Left in storytelling suspense left us all wanting more. Yep. Exactly. when he shut down more. Yep. And then your uncle has a card he's not using. Technically, I do have a card that I'm not using. Very much, yes, I do. I think I do have a card. Power supply. That one says reset switch. So, if I'm thinking this, okay, yeah, this just goes in. Again, cable's in the way. Good gracious, come on, dude. Give me a break. Just trying to get this computer together before 2 o'clock in the morning. It is 1 o'clock, oh my God. This one, power switch, 1 and 2. And power switch, reset switch goes there, power switch goes across from it. It goes across from it. Okay, so the power switch is on the other side. Over here, I guess I need to put it in the right way here. Come on. Come on. You can do it. Oh my goodness. What is going on? There we go. Oh. Ow. Okay. That's in there. Okay. Whew. Power switch, LED power, LED, oh wow, wait, plus, then minus, so plus goes on the edge, minus goes, so let's do minus first since minus is going to be in between there. Yay, got it in there. Yay. All right, now where does this go? This adapter, the adapter goes to something, but I'm not sure what. I got a few little cables here that are, it's kind of hanging out. I want to say the F panel, is the F panel front panel? Yeah. All right, so this is the front panel. So this corresponds to this, I think. I think it just, do these go together? 1, 2, 3, 4. And then this connects to that. I don't want to force it through there though. It doesn't seem like it. It's supposed, it's 4. I don't know. All right, that's connected. I think that's supposed to go there. I think. I am so nervous. Looks like we got 5 viewers. Five viewers, but only 3 people. Oh, maybe it was only 3 people in the chat, but it's 5 viewers. Okay. Maybe I count as a viewer? Do I count? I want to go swimming. That was an Aqua Team Hunger Force joke. Let's see. 18. 18. What is 18? I realize there are no numbers. everything is numbered, but nothing corresponds to an actual number. One, two, three. Oh, that's just the order. Okay, so that's for the fan. Okay, we're gonna put that off to the side. Mainly because it's getting confusing. All right, so we have our HD audio that goes all the way over here. I know that one. That's one of the ones that you can't really get wrong because one says audio and the other one says audio. Ow. Ugh. I'm not sure what this one is though. Only goes in one way. Only goes in one way. Cool, that's connected. So in theory, we have the motherboard connected to the power supply. We have the front panel LED lights, the hard drive light, the power button, all that stuff, that's connected. We have a couple stray wires that I'm not sure exactly where they go. They're not marked anything specific. They could, oh, you know what? I think they're fans. Yeah, fan here, yeah, sorry, those are fans. These are fan cables, so we need to find system fan. Where's a fan? Where is a fan? I need fans. And also, I need to figure out where this goes. Subscriber, system fan, pump fan. Okay, so the pump fan, that's gonna go there. System fan 3, system fan 4. Am I in the way of the camera? I think I am. Actually, I don't think you can even see what I'm doing. Yeah, I must have pushed that back. Let's do this. Sorry. Sorry, people. Let's see. Tech Supreme. I'm viewing on my TV while I edit a gameplay video for YouTube. Well, it's been fun. Oh, yeah, yeah. All right, Jordan. Have a good one. It's fun hanging out. Last night for me. Technically, yes, because of the chat that is pulled up in OBS and have gotten any tier 3s. Have I gotten any tier 3s in Marvel Future Fight? Huh. Dude, Marvel Future Fight. Come on now. Come on now. I'm a whale. I've spent way too much money on Marvel Future Fight for it to be a mobile game. I swear. Like, the amount of money that I put into this mobile game, I probably could have bought a couple PS5s. So, but yeah, Marvel Future Fight, I have a lot of tier 3s. I'll share those with you later. As a matter of fact, I might do it on the stream. Who knows? Let's see. I need to get this fan in. There's one fan, and then there's a fan over here. System fan 2. Let's go ahead and toss it right there. And I saw that Tech was on. I appreciate you watching the stream, watch me go through this and put together the cable management is going to be horrible, but put together a computer that, I really don't know what I'm doing, but I like to pretend that I do. And you know what? There is a screw. I should have put that screw in. There's no screw back here. But yeah, I've been working on this computer for a little minute since I started the stream. And yeah, we're live, and so you're hearing and seeing me mess up and fumble and say so many doggone times that I'm getting annoyed with it. So I appreciate you watching the stream, definitely. I know you probably have better things to do, and I appreciate you hanging out. think that's in. Okay, so that's, I think that was the last screw that I need to put in. I probably just forgot to put that in. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Could have sworn there were 9 spots, but I think this middle section had just had the peg there. So I think we're good. Yeah, we're good. So we have the fans connected. We have the 32 gigabytes of memory. We have the AMD 7, Ryzen 7 3700X. Then we have the Evo Plus. It is late. The Samsung Evo Plus SSD here. And then also we have the motherboard, which is the MSI motherboard. It's a B450 Max, I want to say. Yeah. We still have to put the graphics card in. And I realized that after getting all this stuff in, we're still actually missing the Blackmagic card, which is going to have all of our video inputs on it. So I'm going to check to make sure the graphics card we bought is just a graphics card and doesn't have the inputs on it. I'm pretty sure it just has outputs for video. I think that's why we got that one. But we were going to go with the secondary card for the inputs for the streaming devices, all of our cameras and things like that. So we can get that sweet, sweet bokeh, as Maddie Hipolia likes to say. Get those nice, crispy, crispy, clean video images and streams. So just looking up the CPU port, or the cable that goes from the power supply to the CPU. I'm just connecting that up, the one that says CPU. So that's connected. I think that's connected the right way. I like to get this stuff to seat in there. Yeah, that's fully in there. Awesome. And in regards to cable management, I'm not doing horrible. I mean, I'm not doing great either. There's some stragglers over here, and then this cable goes all the way across here, which really shouldn't, because the graphics card is going to be fairly big. It's going to go here, and then I'm sure the other one's going to go here. So I might have to, that was probably too loud. Sorry, I'm right next to the microphone. Probably just move this down a little bit. Maybe put this around here. Will that go? I think that'll go. Yeah. All right, so we're not doing too bad. We're not doing too bad. I'm gonna put this in here, and I'll pull it from the other side just to kind of get it taut. And this still is kind of annoying me just a little bit, because I'm afraid that that's just at an awkward angle. It might be, it's fine. It's probably fine. Okay. So now that we have everything in here that needs to be connected to a cable besides the cooler, we're gonna put the thermal paste on the top of the cooler here, and we're gonna get that taken care of, because I don't want anything to happen to this. I want this to get covered up before we move forward. So I'm just going to have a seat, get comfortable, and not break the tempered glass. Try not to break the tempered glass that goes on here, that's on the floor, that probably shouldn't just be laying on the floor. But I have no place to put it right now that's safe. Okay, so that's out of the way. We're gonna go ahead and grab the cooler and the thermal paste. So let's grab the thermal paste first. I'll show you that. All right, so this is the thermal paste. Oh, it's upside down. So this is the thermal paste. Is that really just blown out, like super blown out? Let's do that. Yeah, you can read that, pretty much. Okay, so this is the thermal paste that I'm using. It's Corsair, just like the SD, or not the SD, but the memory sticks that I put in. It is the, so basically we're just gonna put a little X pattern on here. Boop, boop. And then pop on the cooler, and then we'll figure out how the cooler is gonna kind of be installed in here. I'm thinking it's just gonna go across on this side here. It's got a couple screws in here. I think I can pull these out. Do these just come out? It's weird. They have screws, but I don't know if this whole thing comes out or if it stays in there. So I'm just leave it as is. for right now, but I'm gonna grab the cooler and see what we got going. So we have the, I'm just gonna read from the box because I'm not that cool to memorize things. We have the Cooler Blaster, or the Cooler Master, sorry, Cooler Master. Oh, you can't even see that because of the overlay here. We have the Master Liquid ML, is that L? Yeah, ML240L, and it is V2, it's RGB, which doesn't matter because I didn't get it because it had RGB. I got it because it was a liquid cooler and it was a right price. So this is by Cooler Master, obviously not sponsored by anybody here, but I am open to any sponsor, just to let you know. If Corsair, you want to hit me up, or MSI, you want to hit me up, hey, look, send me some free stuff. I will review it. I'll turn this channel into a freaking doggone tech channel, don't you know? And we can go over all these tech stuff and do art on top of that. Maybe that's my niche. Yeah, maybe that would be my thing. Like, I'll do comic work and then I'll build a computer like every once in a while. Oh my goodness. Let's go to the chat before I do that. You on TV? Okay. Well, it's been fun. Cool. I think I said bye to Jordan. Oh, he said he's back. I'm back. Hey, let's see. Technically, yes, because on the chat that is pulled up in OBS. Okay, I already read that. Can't say I'm surprised. That's really funny. What are you guys doing with the old streaming PC? That's a good question. I don't know. I think the old streaming PC is going to go to the other side so we can use Easy Worship on that. And then the one that's using Easy Worship, I don't even know. Pastors probably can use that pretty much anywhere in the building. Mainly because of the fact that we don't want to throw anything away that can be used for something else. I mean, even if it's a glorified calculator at this point. So we may donate it, or I'll leave that up to the leadership to determine what they want to do with the other computer. We may even Frankenstein it, just grab all the parts off of it and just kind of cannibalize it and grab all the parts from it and add it to something else, even add it to this if we need to. But yeah, I'm not sure. Let's see. Question: what is the primary duty of the liquid cooler? Okay, so fans essentially, and this is, I didn't realize this was in the way here. Fans on a computer keep the computer cool so it doesn't overheat when it does all the processing. And I'm this is like very high level because honestly I'm not the tech guy to really explain that, but I'm gonna do my best to explain it the best way I know how. But essentially, the liquid cooler is the best way to cool your motherboard and your processor, because of the liquid is just cooler. You don't want your processor to overheat when it's doing its thing, so basically you want to cool it. And generally you would use heat sink and a fan. That's what most computers have, is heat sink. They have like the metal heat sink that goes in there. I don't know if you ever seen it or know what it looks like. Actually, I can show it to you. It's in this box right here. So most computers have one of these, which is just the CPU fan. This is the fan that goes on top of your processor, and it keeps it cool because it connects through this heat sink right here, and all of the heat dissipates through these coils and through all this other stuff, and it cools it down and keeps it nice and cool. I don't know how many times I'm going to say cool. It's going to turn into a drinking game. Every time I say cool, you have to take a shot. Don't drink. Anyway, this is the wholesome channel. Basically, it keeps it nice so it doesn't overheat. That's the basic of it. I'm sure if you just type in what does a heat sink do in Google, or if you go to YouTube and say why use liquid cooling, you probably have a way better and way more detailed answer for that. I got it because of I've been programmed to think that that's the best way to cool a computer's CPU. And I probably got that. It's like just in the zeitgeist, like liquid cooling is better than just fans, and you want to have as many fans as possible on your computer. So yeah, most of the tech channels that build computers, they end up doing a liquid cooling. So I just decided to go liquid cooling for this computer. I would have gone and done that for mine. I didn't have enough money. I may still go back and change that out. I'm not sure if I can even do that, because the heatsink is not like an adhesive. It's not like it becomes like a bond. You can kind of just pull it off. It's just kind of like a paste that comes off. So, but anyway, this is the actual fan that came with the actual processor. But we're not going to use that because we're going to use the liquid cooler. So I'm going to put this back in the box. It's got some cable in here that we probably need, but I'm sure the liquid cooler has that already. So I'm going to open up the box. I already took the plastic off. You know what? I want to get some space here. I want to clear this out. It looks weird because I keep like flipping my hair. All right. Ooh, that's dirty. All right, let's get all this mess out of the way. Straighten up my tablecloth here. All right, let's get the box over here. Let's open her up, let's see what we got. Where's it open? Down here? Oh, over here? No, on the side, maybe? Yeah, on the side. That's different. All right, we got a lot of stuff in here. We have fan number one. Or actually, we already have two fans in the case. So that's fan number three, fan number four. And then we have the actual cooler part. So this is like basically like a radiator for your computer. Got the I don't even know if you're supposed to touch those or not touch those, so I just touched it, so oh well. We got the wires to connect to the CPU fan and probably LED strip, so we have that. We have the manuals, which we're gonna throw those over here and probably need them later and not know where they are. Wow, this has a ton of little cables and things. Cables and screw posts and all kinds of stuff and brackets. This is going to be a lot more complicated than I thought it was going to be. Okay, so let's put that off to the side. And anything else in here? Desiccant. Don't eat that. It's not good for you. Oh, hit the camera again. All right, so we're going to grab this. We're going to put this off to this over here. We're going to grab the box. And we're gonna put that over here. And we're keeping all the boxes and stuff like that. When you do anything for like a nonprofit, or even something for profit or whatever the case is, then you want to always keep like receipts, boxes, stuff like that, because you never know when they need to take that stuff back. They may have warranties, stuff like that. You don't want to throw that stuff away. So this is a cool little fan here. Look at that. It's got a little, you can't see it. Oh, there it is. You see it's got a little shimmer to it when it spins. So that's cool. And then the cables are braided. That's a cool feature too. So we have two of those. It says Sickle Flow 120. Now, I'm not sure if this brand is like a name brand or anything. Cool Master, I mean, it has the word cool in the name, so I mean, like, it's gotta be good, right? let's see. So we just pull this off. Remove label before install. Okay, so it says warning. Remove label before install, which I get that. We gotta remove the label. We gotta remove the plastic before we get it on the computer or on the CPU. But can we get some more instruction? Maybe I should check the instruction manual. Is this? Oh, it's a warranty. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so there's apparently a lot to this. I'm just going to, can I, oh man, I really got to adjust that. I don't know if I can do it during the stream though, but I want to adjust the, when it shut down and it came back up. I don't know if this will let me adjust it while I'm streaming though. Let me see. I tried this last time and it all shut down on me. See, compared to most liquid coolers I've seen, this one seems simpler than the others, but most simple things look cooler, and Cool Master is pretty good from what I've seen. Oh, okay, cool. Cool. I'm saying cool, and the name is Cool Master. That wasn't intentional. That was another community reference. But I'm afraid to hit the configure button, because if I hit configure, then it's going to probably shut down my OBS, and I'm hoping it doesn't, but I need to. Let's do this. I'm going to switch to this one. Yeah. I'm going to switch to this. Take that off. And then hopefully it'll let me adjust this since it's not being shown. That's funny. Okay, so flip that over. All right. But it did let me adjust it. So adjust. I want to get the exposure down a bit. There we go. Nope. Not enough. Right there. Perfect. And autofocus is fine. Zoom is fine. I want to keep that same. And we're going to hit apply and okay. I'm going to close that, and then we can go back to this, and let's try this one. There we go. Yeah. Okay. So now we can read this without it being too blown out. All right. So this scroll is the instructions on how to put this together. So these are all the parts here. Let's see. So we got, apparently it says we're supposed to connect the fan. To this like radiator. So this is for, oh, okay. So this is the different models. Gotcha. So which one do I have? I have the 240L, this one. I have the dual fan. All right, so we just connect the two fans to this through the screw. Oh, that's really easy. Just connect the two fans, and then you put the bracket. You put the brackets on it. The brackets. You put. I hope I don't break it. You put the brackets on this, and that goes onto Z motherboard. Oh, that goes under the motherboard. No. Don't tell me that. Don't tell me that. No. That goes under the motherboard. Can I get to that? I think I can get to that. I'm pretty sure I can get to that. All right. So let's do this first. Oh, I hope I don't have to pull that motherboard off. That's exactly what John was saying. John Seward. Jordan. Sorry, Jordan. Why did I say John? Sorry. This is exactly what Jordan was talking about. Let's do this. He was saying that most people he sees puts the screw in the corners. Or maybe it was Leon. I don't know. Somebody said it in the chat. I should just put the screws in the corners. And I didn't listen. So now they're saying I told you so. All right. So which way do these go? They don't really indicate it, to be honest. I need to figure out which way these go so I can know where the cables, which side the cable goes on. It doesn't really say though. The diagram doesn't even show the wiring. So I'm going to assume And you know what happens when you assume that if you just go in the same direction as the words, then we should be fine. So we put one here and put one here. Have the words going the correct way. I think this would work. Yeah, and all the wires come out. Yeah, that's perfect. All right, that wasn't hard to figure out at all. I'm just making it way too hard. I'm overthinking it. All right, it runs in the family apparently. So we have this here, and it is 139. I'm hoping that I will be able to finish this build. If not, then I definitely do appreciate you all sticking around for me to figure this out. It's very possible that I may not finish this build tonight. I may end up... we got more thermal compound in here. We may end up doing this or finishing this tomorrow. Because once I get this fan in... I think I still have to get the graphics card in, and then, actually, no, I might be able to finish it tonight. I might be able to, we'll see. Yeah, because I have to get the graphics card in, and once I get the graphics card in, then I think that's it. I think that's all. So, we'll see. Got these long ones? Yep, the long ones here. Giggity. Pay no attention to me. I am sleepy. That's what it is. Up late night. To be honest, though, this is about the time where I would still be up normally on a regular day, even if I wasn't streaming right now, which I hope I'm still streaming. Yeah, I'm still streaming. Okay. Yeah. That was you. Oh, Leon, that was you that said that? That normally put the screw in the corners? Well, I want to give credit where credit is due. If you said that, then yes. Thank you. You did say that, if you said that. And you can say I told you so, because you were right. Well, I'm hoping I don't actually have to pull that off. If I don't have to pull it off, then we're good. And I can move on. If I have to pull the motherboard off to get this bracket on... I'm probably going to call it a night and just finish this tomorrow. Because, I can definitely live stream again tomorrow. Because this is fun. I like this. This is definitely fun doing this. Again, this is one of those things where it's not what the channel is, but who says that it has to be just art? It can be art and technology. Maybe that's what that, like I said, maybe that's what my niche is. And draw a picture and build a computer. Draw a picture and talk about cameras. Draw a picture and hopefully get sponsored by Apple and get a free computer. let's see. All right, that's on there. This is solid though. It's like metal. It's like a fan, but it's metal. It's not plastic or anything. Let's see. So these wires, what is this? We got brackets. Brackets on brackets on brackets. I'm not sure what I'm looking at. Is this? This is the LED. Okay, so this is for the LED. I forgot, yeah, this lights up. So this is LED. This is LED. And this one is LED. So we got these three LED cables. And I'm assuming these are extension cables. Let's see. Yeah. Yeah, these looks like... Or not necessarily extension. These are... You connect these to here, so we'll just do this. And I don't think it matters either. Yeah, they're not marked. Okay, cool. So we just connect arrow to arrow. So there's two little arrows. I don't know if you can see that. I'll get it closer. There is an arrow here, and then there's an arrow there. So you just connect these like so. That should go in easier. Okay, cool. Connects those like so. And the cool thing is, these are all my LED connectors. Yeah. This is LED connectors. LED connectors. Oh, that's not the right one. That's the wrong side. So, the new Dresden book came out from Dresden Files by Jim Buscher. Now it's a book review channel. We're just going to mix it all up here. He came out with his new book, Peace Talks, and I read it. Or actually, to be more accurate, I listened to it because I listen to audiobooks while I'm doing stuff, especially stuff like this, if I wasn't streaming, obviously. And I listened to it, and it was good, but it was so disappointing in regards to, like, story. Obviously, that makes no sense. Okay, so let me elaborate. Essentially, he's like, oh, it's a good book, but the story was horrible. No, it didn't give me that Dresden Files feel because it's like a two-parter. So just as the story was getting ramped up, he ended the book. And I'm like, no. So now we got to wait until, I think, luckily, though, we only have to wait until, I think, September for Battlegrounds, the next book. And I wasn't mad, but I was like so disappointed. I'm like, I wanted more. I waited so long for this book, and why is it not giving me everything I want out of it? And yeah, it sounded just like that. I said that just like that when I right after I got done reading it. I immediately got on Discord and talked to my friend Brian, who's also read the book. And we were both like, why, Jim? Why? You just teased us with this little short story. It felt like a short story. Like, it didn't even feel like a full book. But that's how good Jim Buscher is at telling stories and things like that. You forget how much time. I think it was 12 hours, maybe, I think. Which is relatively short in regards to books. I apologize for not looking at the camera. I'm not looking at your face when I'm talking, but I'm trying to do two things at once. But yeah, it's a relatively short book. All of his books are, especially compared to like The Wheel of Time or something like that. And for all of you that don't know what The Wheel of Time is, Robert Jordan, Brandon Sanderson, Robert Jordan wrote a book, a series, and it's a high fantasy series. And it's highly acclaimed. It's really old, not really old, but it's old enough, and it's been out for a while. And they're long. Like, these books, like the audio books, are like 48 hours long and stuff like that. It's ridiculous. They're super dense. Yeah, it's hundreds of hours of reading time or listening time if you're doing audiobooks. And I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing here. Okay, so I need to focus. Got this done. We need to pull this off, put the paste on, put that down, put the brackets on. And once we put the brackets on, then we screw everything down. Okay. So we pull this off and then we put the brackets on. But yeah, what I was getting back to was the fact that, sorry, I'm all over the place. Have you seen a new? Yes. Umbrella Academy is dope. And it gave me everything. I was more satisfied with Umbrella Academy, and I waited less time than I was with Jim Butcher's new book, Peace Talks. Not saying that the book was bad. Please hear me when I say Peace Talks was a great book. It just was not satisfying. It was equivalent to craving pizza, getting like half of a slice, like a sliver of a slice. And it's like, you got the pizza, but you didn't get enough. It's like, can I at least get another slice or just the rest of that slice? you know, you just wanted more of it, and it just wasn't so frustrating. Anyway, I'm sure there's other analogies that people can draw from that as well, which we're PG though, or at least we try to be. All right, so where are the black? Oh, these are the brackets. Brackets here. What are these brackets? Which ones? Back to the instructions. Okay, so we use those brackets. Screw posts. We'll put the screw posts down. The screw posts connect to the back bracket, and then we use the other brackets. Just screw that down. I think D. So where does D go? Giggity. Sorry. Couldn't help myself. Let's see. Okay, those going on top. They go on top. And it's based off of, it looks like it's based on the configuration you're using. So yeah, they could just give you a whole bunch of extra stuff. I hate that because, well, I like it because they give me what I need, but I hate it because of the fact that I don't always know which one I need. So we're going to... We're gonna look at the motherboard and check and see which one we actually need, because I actually don't know. I'm just gonna move all this over to my side table, off camera. Slide everything away. Slide to the left. All right, we're gonna grab, we lost our light again. My apologies. Oh my goodness. Let's turn it this way. Let's get my light back. See if we can get the light back. Come on, light. Aziz, light. Come on. There we go. Yeah, my ring light has a short in it. It's very annoying. So, now what? I need to... There are no holes behind the okay, so sorry, let me show you what I'm looking at. I'm looking here. This is where my processor is. There are no holes back here. So if there are no holes back here, that means everything I need is on the top. So I use that other configuration. I guess the one, let's put it here. So I use the configuration where it actually works, everything is on the top. So let me, unless I pull these out, do I unscrew these? Maybe I unscrew them. Hold on, let me see. I don't think these screw holes actually line up. Yeah, those screw holes don't even line up. So let me take this out. Oh my God, it's almost 2 o'clock. Let's see. Let me check the chat. Sorry. Blah, blah, blah. You also could have looked at the box to see what it should have looked like. Very true. I'll wait to say it. Oh, thou told you so. Yeah. Let's see. Yes, part two live. If it has to come off. Yeah. True. If it has to come off, I'll say I told you so. But till then, I'll hold off. Well, yeah. Have you watched the new season of Umbrella Academy? Yes, I think I already answered that. Sorry, the chat. I'm super slow. It was awesome. I already commented on that. I just started watching it. It's really good, Jordan. Definitely, definitely check it out. I binge watched it in one night, and I was up to about 4 o'clock in the morning, only because 3:30, and that was I think on a Friday night, so it was like Friday night, Saturday night, something like that. Let's see. Da-da-da. Makes sense. No spoilers, but it has to be my fave live action shows based off of comics I've seen in a while. Yeah, most definitely. There's a lot right now, though. There's a lot on Netflix and a lot on. Sorry, I got the straight dread here or straight lock here. There's a lot on Netflix right now that is based on comics, and I didn't realize that Lock and Key is based on a comic or graphic novel. Comic, graphic novel, same thing. The Old Guard, also Warrior Nun. There's a lot of them, tons of them right now. And yeah, as of right now, I think it's a toss up between Old Guard. I really love that. It was a really good movie. And what did I drop? Oh, okay. Whew, just the screwdriver, not the cooler. All right, Old Guard, which was a really good movie, and also, I'm so clumsy. What is going on? And Umbrella Academy. Gosh, I'm like, I can't talk and hold things in my hand, apparently. Is this, like, going across the air? How does that go? Okay, anyway, back to building this, because obviously I am probably stalling because I'm afraid to put this together because I don't want it to not work. So let me grab the parts that I need. Now, according to this, not that one, according to this schematic, I think Intel LG A, Intel LGA, Intel and AMD. I need to find the one that has the right screw posts for what I'm looking at. That's not it. That's not it. That's not it. What is this accent you're doing? It is horrible. Whatever it is, it's like jumping back and forth between seven different regions. Okay, what do we got? What do we got? What do we got? What do we got in the chat? Bum, 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 bum. I enjoyed the first season, and I've watched one episode of the second season. Yeah, it's really good. Jordan, definitely finish that out. I binged it all at once. It's really good. Yes, definitely, Leon, it is. I like Titans too, but disappointed I hear they're canceling it. The Old Guard was great too. Yeah, I was watching Titans. Titans was pretty good. I actually dig that. I didn't. There was a couple aspects I didn't like, which was the whole Batman thing. I've never really been a fan of like just kind of throwing him arbitrarily into a story like that. It was kind of weird, especially since he didn't actually get into the bat suit, from what I understand. And maybe that's a spoiler that I probably shouldn't have said anything about. Sorry if it is. How does this go in here? What the heck, bro? Okay, so that, oh, okay. I think we're, does that go on top of there? Yeah, so I'm not really a fan of that, but I did like the show. The show was good. I liked it. It was enjoyable, and the characters were cool. A lot of people had a lot of flack about Starfire and how she was kind of portrayed at first. And I think mainly because they just kind of made her black. And I think people get upset when people do that. That's a whole nother story, a whole nother thing. I'm of two minds in regards to that. Even though I love Jorah Mormont, or Jorah, I loved him in Game of Thrones. And honestly, he probably could have been a okay Batman, maybe, but he was just really, for his age and how they were telling the story, I just didn't really care for it. But that actor, he's a cool actor. I love him in other stuff that he's been in. I'm of two minds in regards to like taking an established character and making like a black version of that character. The problem with this is it's almost like you're saying that there are no good characters that you can create that are of color, you know, from scratch. Like you have to regurgitate some other character to make them, you know, make them to basically you're like, yeah, we don't want to make a cool black character, or not just black person of color. Pretty much any person other than just like white or whatever. It's like, you know, we can't make this character stand on its own two feet. We have to like attach him to a legacy that already exists. And they've done it successfully for a couple different characters, like the Flash with Wally West, and actually Wally West wasn't that great, but definitely Miles Morales. Miles Morales is probably the biggest success story in regards to that, in my opinion, as well as John Stewart, Green Lantern. That's the Green Lantern I know, is John Stewart. Hal Jordan was never really my Green Lantern, because I didn't really get into DC comics as much as a younger person. But Justice League, the animated series, or Justice League Unlimited, those shows featured John Stewart as Green Lantern. So that's how I know Green Lantern. So in those regards, they were good, but they're so few and far between. It's like, it's a situation where it's like, just create a new character with a person of color as that main character, and let them, and make them good, and then they'll be successful. But on the flip side of that, when it comes to movie adaptations, TV show adaptations, I see it as like kind of an alternate universe, and I'm like, yeah, if you switch the character up, it's not a big deal. I'm not gonna be outraged because you made, you know, a character that was white in the comics, black, or, you know, East Indian, or, you know, Hispanic in the movie or TV show. It's not that serious. I'm not going to throw a hissy fit because of that. And in some cases, if they do it right, if they do it really well, then I'm going to be happy about it. They're like, oh, that's cool. But I just think when it comes to creating new characters or in a comic or in a story, instead of just saying, oh, now we just have alternate universe, you know, where everybody's a different color, and here, there you go. Because you know you're not going to keep it that way. You know Marvel is going to switch it right back. you know, they're never going to kill off, you know, a main character that's been there for years and years and years, and then bring it back as a different color, and then keep the status quo. They're going to bring back the original character that everybody knows and loves. Now, there's some one-offs. There's some people characters that have switched over, or whatever you want to call it, and stayed that way. But again, it's very few and far between, and it's really hit or miss. Really hit or miss. Just create a cool character of color and call it a day. Was that a spoiler? Oh, was Bruce Wayne back? Oh, hold on. Sorry for the spoilers. What spoilers, Jordan? I'm pretty sure everybody knows that Bruce Wayne is Batman. let's see. It's cool. I haven't found a way to watch it, so I don't really care. Jordan said Netflix. Leon said Titans is on Netflix. I'm reading every comment because there's only like five of us in here. So let's see. Yep. Okay. Oh, okay. So Leon, just to give you a heads up, unless you have a VPN, I don't think Titans is on Netflix. It's only on Netflix if you use like. Yeah, that's somebody that lives in this building driving the car like that. It's crazy. Crazy, living downtown. Anyway, Titans is only on Netflix if you're not in the U.S. So if you have like a VPN, like ExpressVPN or like NordVPN or something like that, switch your region to U.K. or some other country and you'll see Titan in the search when you search for it. But yeah. Yeah. Okay. So back to this. Yeah, I'm definitely stalling because I don't know what to do anymore. I think I might be calling this a night. It is 2 o'clock and I have to get up and I'm going to be working all day tomorrow, answering phones and things like that at my regular job. So basically right here is where I left off. I have to put the cooling, I have to put the cooler here. But I have these brackets. I think I just have to unscrew these brackets. But the problem is those screw holes don't line up with this bracket, which I think is supposed to go under the chassis. So that doesn't line up at all. And there are no other holes there for these for this to line up. So I'm assuming this is not something that I'm going to be using. It was only for that other configuration. Sorry about that. So yeah, I'm just going to be using this, which even this is not, yeah, that doesn't line up either. This goes with this bracket. So I'm not actually sure how this is supposed to attach. And it might just be too tired to try to figure it out, to be honest. I think that might be the case. Because I can't even remember where I set it down. So we got screws here. Oh, that's right here. Okay. So that sort of fits. But I don't know if this is supposed to go on or. Yeah, because that wouldn't actually. This would stick down too far below that. But then it looks like this goes on to here. But then that doesn't seem like it fit. Maybe. Okay. I just used this post. Okay, got it. All right, we figured it out. But I do need to put the posts on here. All right, so if I had a bigger desk, I would move this over. But since I don't, I'm just going to do it all in here. I'm just going to wires. All right, so I'm going to, first of all, change the camera angle. So you can see. All right. So you can see inside. So basically, because this has these two posts on them, I just attach them to these hooks here, which that's what the other piece was for. I was just complaining about having too many pieces because I didn't know what to do with them. And if I didn't have that, then I wouldn't be able to use these little brackets here with the little hooks on them to hook onto the things there. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna put these metal pieces here on the bottom of here some kind of way. some way that's going to keep that on there. Maybe they go this way. I'm not sure. Look at the instructions. Yes. Okay. So we don't need those. We don't need these brackets at all. They go over there. All we do need are these screws that connect to it. Which connect on the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just gonna put those off to the side. All right. Let's get this party started, shall we? Okay. We need. So we have these two pieces. Okay, so they go top and bottom this way. I think. Screw from the bottom. Start from the bottom right here. No? Yes? No? All right. I thought you had a dragon in the basement. It sounds like a dragon. I swear, that guy, we know who it is too. But, well, I mean, we don't know the person, but I know that they're in the building. It's really annoying, but not that they would ever be watching this live stream to be like, hey, are you talking about me? If you are watching this live stream and it is you outside with a very, very loud car, can you please not do that? It's just courteous to not rev your car engine at 2 o'clock in the morning. It's just common courtesy, bro. You know, all love, no disrespect. Don't think I'm coming at you or anything crazy like that. But yeah, it's just, you know, some people gotta work in the morning, and you know, I understand. You probably living your life, which is cool, but you know, let other people live, bro. Let them sleep. Anyway, I don't want to start anything. Somebody might find out where I live and be like, I know that guy. He was complaining about the car outside. I just realized you all can't see. Oh, you can see what I'm doing straight ahead. Yeah. You can see me fumbling around with this. Straight ahead. I'm just putting the screw in here. If you're wondering why I'm fumbling around so much, it's because it is 2:12 in the morning, and I've been up since earlier this morning. So I'm a bit on the tired side. All right. So that's all on there. Now we got to put the thermal paste onto the AMD. Now I just realized I bought this this thermal paste, or I had this bought, but the cooler actually came with thermal paste also. So I'm not sure. I'm gonna use the one that I bought instead of the one that that came with it, because the stuff that came with it probably is like the cheap stuff, and this was kind of more high end. I mean, I don't know if Corsair is considered high end, but I'm just gonna put. Can you all see that? Let's see. I'm just gonna put it right there in the center. Just gonna squeeze out some thermal paste here. Oh no! Oh no! Okay. It's dripping, it's dripping, it's dripping. Oh my goodness, that got all over the thing. All right, so hopefully that doesn't do any damage. Oh my god. Again, this is not a tutorial. This is not a tutorial. Do not watch me do this and be like, this is how to put together a computer. Good gracious. I need to flip this around, maybe? Let's do that, yeah. Let's do that. See if I can keep the wires out of the thermal paste. Fan's gonna go there, so I want the cooling cables to come this way. I cannot believe I let that. I didn't know that it was gonna drip like that. Come on. Get on there. Get in your home. You took good for your home. All right, there we go. Finally, finally, finally. Come on, come on, come on. Ooh, that was an ordeal. Why is that just spinning though? Tighten. That's crazy. This thing is just spinning. It's not tightening down. What is going on? Okay. I need to sit down because I'm tired. What is going on? Okay. That's on there, right? Why won't it tighten down? It's just spinning. Does it have like a spring in it or something? Like, what's going on? What's the deal? Oh my gosh, what is going on with this? This is okay. Come on. Come on. It's definitely on the CPU here, but now these posts don't want to screw in. There it goes. Good gracious. Okay. Yes, there we are. Yeah. Yeah. All right, cool. Cool, 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 cool. Cooler, or the cooler is on.
Thank goodness.
Oh, all right. So now that the cooler is on, oh, that was an ordeal. Okay, so cooler's on. What's this? Can't remember what this one is. Still don't know what that is. Let's close that back up. I don't know what that is. Oh my goodness. Let's see. We need to connect the CPU fans and the LED lights. LED lights, obviously secondary to the CPU fan. Let's find out where that is. We have system fan 1. We have CPU fan 1 over here. And it's only one way it can go on. Can you see that? Yeah, you can basically see that for the most part. It's a little dark, but you can see it. So that went there. So then we have, these are LEDs. We're just gonna put that off to the side for right now. We're not worried about lights. But what we are worried about, not necessarily worried about, we are concerned with, it's the same thing, is getting these fans connected. So that goes to another fan's comm. System fan. Oh, that's not going to be long enough. So we can disconnect this system fan, connect it over yonder. Will that go over there? I think they might go over there. Oh, I'm in the way of the camera, aren't I? No, probably. Oh my goodness. Pump fan. Okay. You know what? I think this is the pump. That's the pump. So system fan. Okay. So we can just connect this one here to right down here. Doesn't go. Get up there. Okay, so that's system fan connected. This one is system fan. Then we have, that's LED system fan. All right, that's LED. And there's the other system fan. Boom, 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 boom. Where are you going, though? Disconnect you. Put you here. And then we could put this guy, or girl, right somewhere. Let's see, where can this go? Yeah, I've kind of thrown the idea of cable management out the window at this point. So if this looks atrocious, I really don't care. It is way too late in the night or early in the morning, whichever one you want to choose. RGB, that goes here. There's an arrow. Should be an arrow there. Should be an arrow. Point to... Where'd she go? Maybe. Most possible. Maybe not. Let's see. RGB. If I'm breathing really hard. Oh, my goodness. If I'm breathing really hard in the microphone, just let me know. Because I'm super tired. And I turned the AC off so it wouldn't be loud. And I think that was a bad choice. Because I am hot. Warm. Okay, let's see. Will this fit all the way across the way over here? No, that's right, because I kept it over here only because of the fact that I haven't mounted the fan yet. So I don't know where that's going to go. So I'm going to move this one. This is a CPU fan. It probably can be rerouted to a different area. So I'm just going to reroute it. I'm pretty sure that it's like right. It's probably just Velcroed over here. Most likely. Let me see. I can't flip this over because I haven't mounted the fans yet, but I'm just going to tilt it a bit. See if I can get some more. Yeah, that goes all the way around. Okay, so we can move this. Which I think I was going to move this earlier, and I decided not to. Where can it come up at? It could come up right here, maybe? Where'd it go? Here? Oh, it didn't even go through. There we go. Oh my goodness. Okay. So we're going to connect this to system fan. No, we can't do that because that's dumb. Can't connect that there. I have to put the two graphics cards in. That would be super dumb. What was I thinking? It's got to be another system fan port somewhere around here. That can come from a different angle. Pump fan is over there. Wait, what is... What's coming from here? Let me figure this out. That's RGB. This is going to the fan. Where's the other cable for the fan? Is it this? Okay, yeah, that's there. I'm gonna disconnect that one and connect it to the pump fan, maybe? I think it is the pump. What we got in the chat? Oh my goodness, I'm so tired. Let's see. Yeah, it's here in Canada. Yep. Okay. Have you ever watched a series on Netflix called The Midnight Gospel? It's weird. I watched one episode. I think it was the zombie episode with they were doing an interview with the president. It was weird. Not like Trump president, but like a cartoon version of some random president somewhere. Warrior Nun. Yeah, Warrior Nun is definitely good. It's basically an animated podcast, and I have that show on my list because I wanted to watch it at some point. It's just weird. Honestly, Leon, I'm not going to like call you out there for age or whatever, but you probably shouldn't be watching that show. It might actually be worse than Rick and Morty in regards to content. You actually highly recommend it. That's funny. Okay. for a minute there, I was wondering if that had threads. Oh, I'm super late on the chat, so I don't know. I'm not sure exactly what you're referring to, if it had threads. Yeah, I have no idea. Let's see. So, I feel like I'm so far from being done. It's so tiring. All right. So I got the cooler on the actual CPU. I have the hard drive in, or the SSD in. Memory sticks are in. Motherboard is in. I need to put the graphics card in, and I need to mount the fans some kind of way. I'm not seeing a way to really screw these in, though. That's the thing. This front piece doesn't come off. So how do I get in here to mount these? That's strange. And not doctor. Let's see. They have these screw posts here. Let's see if I unscrew these screw posts, if it opens something. Not to belittle anyone else's state of rest or tiredness, but oh my god, I'm tired. Oh, cool. Okay, so this kind of, what's this? Kind of opens up, I guess. Oh, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Yeah, this comes out. Awesome. Yes. Yeah. All right, now which way does it go, though? Well, I guess it can only go one way. It can only go one, because the piping comes out one side. All right. Well. Oh, I get it. You attach this to here. You attach it to here. Oh, sorry. You guys can't see any of that. I am so sorry. Let's move this over. Boxes, all kinds of stuff. All right, so here's the fan, the fan for the cooler. I'm so clumsy. There's a fan for the cooler. Did I just do that? I hope I didn't just do that. I don't think you're supposed to touch these coils. I think I just broke this. I hope I didn't. Man, that sucks. Okay, so I hope I didn't break that. I really do. These coils are kind of bent now. Oh no, I think I'm making it worse. Stop it. Stop it. No. All right, we're going to leave that alone because I think I may have messed up. I hope I didn't. So we're just going to screw these in because they line up like so. And I need to find the screws. Oh, but I'm so tired. I don't know where the screws are. Let's sit this down somewhere. Okay. We're just gonna sit that down right there for a minute until we can find the screws. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, I think. 6 screws. And I can't remember which bag they were in. I think it's these right here, but we'll see. They don't have writing like the other bag, and they don't have a white, label. This thing has a label. The other one have a label too? No. Okay. I was gonna say, I'm sitting here struggling trying to figure out what it goes to. I just gotta talk on the label on the back. Alright. I promise I'm not that stupid in real life. I mean, I'm kinda stupid, but not that stupid. Okay, so we're just gonna pop this. Which way does it go? Goes this way. Yeah, because this is on the outside. This is going to go on the inside. No. Right, no. So, does it need to go this way? I think so, yeah. Yeah, that makes more sense. Because then it slots in. What do we got? Let's see. No, I already watched it and was talking about Warrior Nun. Okay. I'm sorry. I'm slow on the chat, so let's see. It was the cooler threads kept spinning. Yeah, the cooler. Yeah, they kept spinning because I needed to loosen up the other one to get the other one to get purchase on the threads because it was just like at an angle. It was weird. So I just loosened one side, and as soon as I loosened one side and started tightening the side that I was having problems with, it tightened up, and then I just retightened the other side, so it was good. But it's little things like that, you know, it's like, you think you can just like put together a computer in a night. You think you can do it. You want to do it. You think you can do it in one stream, in one live stream, and have it done before 2 o'clock in the morning. And it turns into 2:35 in the morning. And then you realize that if you don't get all this put in here, you're going to have to do a whole live stream for like a 20 minute maybe finish. I mean, we still have to put software on it and make sure it boots up. But basically, once all the parts get in there, it's just a matter of making sure that the BIOS is set up correctly with the CD. We don't even have a CD-ROM drive. I just realized that. So that's not something we're going to do. Sorry, you can't see what I'm doing, but I'm... Oh, you can see it. You can see it in a small screen. It's fine. Two more screws. I'm going to pop this in. And I think we're going to probably call it a night. We might not be able to... I'll save the power on reveal until after the second stream. I'll probably stream tomorrow night. Tomorrow's Monday. I have to have this done by Wednesday. Actually, technically, I have to have it done by Tuesday so we can have it. Because I still have more software to put on it that the church uses specifically, like for streaming, like the vMix and things like that. Have to put that on there, so it's very possible that this won't get done until I get there. I'm gonna have to bring it to the church and finish it up. Let me see. I know some of the software, a lot of the software is gonna be done at the church. I'm gonna be putting that on at the church because it's stuff that we have licenses for. So, okay, so as of right now, we have the two fans connected to the chassis as well as to the cooler, as well as the cooler connected to the CPU, which are the processor, and the processor connected to the motherboard. We have the SSD connected. We have two 16 gigabytes of memory connected. When we just need to add... I can barely talk at this point. We just need to now put in the graphics card. Once we put the graphics card in, then this is gonna be it. This is it for the build anyway. Anything after this is really, because I do have to get I thought all the parts came in, and I was pretty sure that they did, but I realized that we're still missing the Blackmagic card with the dual HDMI cables, which is actually almost more important than just this regular graphics card that I have. It's not regular, but this graphics card. And I'm unboxing it off screen, and I apologize. A lot of people like to see the unboxing. It was in this, and I took it out. Sorry. It was in this here, this box, and I just pulled it out of the box. The unboxing. There's a this cool MSI container with probably some documentation and a CD in it, which I didn't look at it, but it's probably that. Maybe a cable, if anything. I'm just gonna get this out. Alright. This might be loud with that. Okay. So let's see what we got here. Wow. We have 1, 2 HDMI ports. We have 1, 2 display ports, and we have a DVI-D. Now, actually, I'm going to do this. Now that I think about it, did I just get this and not the Blackmagic card because this was what we... Is this input? Let me check. I got to check to see if this is input. Let me check the box here. That's not in the language that I can understand. Okay, let's try this. Let's try the back. Let's see. It's talking about the cooling. Minimum system requirements. Features. OpenGL, OpenCL. HDR ready. Outputs. They're all outputs. So there are no inputs on this graphics card. So yeah, so we're still missing. We still need to get the Blackmagic card, which we actually have one already in the other computer. And if need be, if the other one doesn't come in time, I can cannibalize that computer and grab the other Blackmagic card, which is, it only has one input, which we only have one camera right now anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But it only has the one input, and we can just take it out of there until the other one comes in the mail, which I have to check because I could have sworn that was on the list to order. I'm almost positive it was. And I don't remember seeing it anywhere. So I'm a little nervous. A bit nervous. Did I scroll? I think I scrolled. Let me see. Oh, wow. How many things did I miss? Warrior 9. Blah, blah, blah. Threads. Yeah, it was a cooler thread spinning. Yeah. I love it when a plan comes together. Yeah. Sorry I'm so late on the chat. Love it when the plan comes together. That is an A-Team reference for all you kids out there. Let's see. I really want to build a computer now. Definitely do it, man. If you have the budget to do it, do it. It's not just something that, you know, you don't have to be an expert to do it. But, I mean, it's definitely fun to do. It can be a little nerve-wracking, but... It's definitely something that you can... What is going on here? Okay, I see. This cable. The one that I thought was going to give me a problem is going to give me a problem. Okay, let's get this over. Why won't it go through? This graphics card is humongous. Oh, that's why. I'm trying to... square peg, round hole. Square peg, round hole.
Square perk. Whoa. All
right, I need to unscrew that. I'm actually afraid to put this graphics card down because I fear that I'm just clumsy enough to put it down and drop it. So I'm just gonna take that one side off, and I'm sitting here touching the contacts like an idiot. People are watching this. If you watch this in the future and you're not watching this live, and you want to say, Joe, you're an idiot, you can definitely do so. I agree with you, because, all right, so that's not the right spot for that.
Okay, so we're going to put this down.
We need to move it over like two spots. Okay. But yeah, if you want to say, Joe, you're an idiot, I won't argue with you at all. I really won't. Promise you I won't. Because I am only partially having fun right now because I'm just so tired. Once I get some rest, I probably could have done this a lot faster since I've actually done it a couple times now. Oh no, did I do that right? Okay. Oh, okay. Awesome. Okay, I thought I was breaking something. I always feel like I'm breaking something when I'm doing this. Okay. All right. Graphics card is in. Now I just gotta stop throwing my hair back like I'm crazy. Find the cable. Oh. This cable that's not ran through anymore. All right, so it only has one set, so that's fine. So we're just gonna run this up and through the bottom here, maybe, like right. Yeah, we'll just do, we'll call that good. Right up through the bottom. I think this might be the last cable that I do tonight. It might be good. Besides the power cable, I might go ahead and try to turn it on. Let's see. Oh, come on. So this has that one little weird thing on it that makes you have to make sure that this is on top. This little bitty piece has to be on top before you can actually get in there. So, awesome. That went right through. Okay. So, it's probably going to interfere with the fan. There's only one way the fan could go, these cooler fans could go in, because these pipes go in this way and they connect here. So I need to make sure that there's nothing in front of these fans that's gonna hit the fan, that's gonna make it do that buzz sound, you know, like you got something in a fan, like a card or like a playing card or whatever. Okay. So that's in there. It only has, mine has two spots here for the VGA cable. And so now I'm kind of looking at this like, where do I stick this other side to keep it from touching anything? But honestly, once we put the other side of the chassis on the glass, you know what? I'm just going to pull that out. I'm just going to pull it out and use this one. Use this side here. Because once I put the glass, the tempered glass on there, it's gonna look like garbage. It's gonna look like garbage, so I don't want it. I don't want it to look like garbage. I want it to work. Oh, come on. There we go. All right. I want it to work rather than look good, but I do kind of want it to look good. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. That's going to hit the fan. That's going to hit that fan. All right. That's good enough. It's good enough for government work. That's what my father used to say. Let's tighten down the graphics card here, and I think we're just going to call it. This is the last piece that I need to put in here tonight anyway, because I don't have anything else. I'm just going to tighten down this card with a couple screws. Ah. But, oh, good gracious. Okay. Sorry. So a lot of you who know me personally know that I don't like curse. So sometimes you want to so bad. But I feel like Yosemite Sam, so I just start making up words. That's a friggin' So, all right. So that. Oh, last one. Last screw. Last screw for the back here. Oh no, it's not the last screw. We still got one. We still got one more screw. I'm gonna put this piece back on, which apparently slides up and down, which I didn't know that. Good gracious, I am just on it today, aren't I? All right. This should be hand tightened, but I'm just gonna screw it in. Okay. Okay. Oh, gee golly, don't y'all know. All right. Alrighty. Actually sound a little bit like Kermit the Frog. Hi-ho, this is Kermit the Frog. When your world looks kind of weird and you wish that you weren't there. All right, so that's all on there. I got some cosmetic things to do on here to make it look pretty, but other than that, we got the graphics card in, we got the CPU and the cooler and the cooler fan, which is liquid cooler, Cooler Master. We got the 32 gigabytes of memory and we got the 250 gigabytes of SSD storage, and we have our 650 watt power supply, which may be enough for now. It's very possible that if we need to upgrade to a newer or more powerful graphics card or something like that, we may need more wattage, but I don't think we will. I think 650 is good enough for what we're doing. But yeah, this is basically the full computer. I got a lot of extra parts I don't know what to do with. A lot of extra screws I don't know what to do with, so You know how that is. But I want to thank you all for watching. Thank you all for sticking with me. I'm going to go ahead and go to the comments real quick here. It says, blah, 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 blah. We kind of distracted you with comments and having fun. Yeah. It wasn't a distraction, but yeah, definitely. That's what slowed it down. Besides the fact that I don't know what I'm doing. Then we have... honestly, we've been doing that the entire stream. Yeah. Let's see. David Finch streams tomorrow night. He moved streams to Monday. Right. You're right. He
he does stream tomorrow night. So that means I don't want to compete with him. I know he streams at like 7 or 8, but then he's on a later time or something like that. So we'll have to see. Like I said, this was pretty impromptu. So I wasn't planning on live streaming this. I was just going to record it and post it. And having it live stream was kind of an extra thing. Is this crooked? That seems crooked to me. Okay. It wasn't crooked. It was just this cable was pressed up against there. I don't like that. It makes me think that that's going to break. Or be bent or something. Okay. So, yeah. All right. I don't think anything else needs to be connected. We're not using SATA drives or anything like that, so we don't have to hook up any of the SATA connectors. There was a couple connections that I looked at that I didn't know what they really went to, but I think all of the wires in the chassis are connected to the board. All of the power supply wires are connected to the board and to the motherboard. That's pretty much it. All the fans are connected. Honestly, the only thing left to do is really to power it up and turn it on and see if the power's on and the fans start blowing. If I get a tone, then I think we can call it good. Let's try it. Because I may not be able to stream. He doesn't go too late. Maybe after Dave's stream. Yeah. Dave doesn't stream too late, so I think he cuts it off at around 9, I want to say, or maybe he starts at 8 or 9. I can't remember because when he moved, I'm not sure if he changed the time, but I'm probably going to be watching that one myself. So it would be crazy if I live streamed building this computer while watching Dave Schmidt's live stream. Yeah. Anyways, we're just going to find something to plug this up to. Let's get our tempered glass in place. Let's put this back. Yeah, that's in there. And we need the screw. Where's the screw? Oh no. I think hoping I didn't drop that screw somewhere. It's one of those finger tighten type bolts that goes in there. Goes right back there in the back. So we might have to hold off on putting the tempered glass piece back in because I can't find the screw that goes to that. All these wires. I'm gonna have to actually clean up at least some of this before I go to bed, only because when I go to work tomorrow, I'm going to be needing this space. So this space needs to be nice and cleared out. But let's see. Oh, I lost my light again. There we go. Okay. I don't really feel like scouring this entire area to find it. Oh, there it is. Said I didn't want to look too hard to find it, and I did anyway. Oh, come on. Come on. Okay, so, oh my goodness, this is just not going through. Is that not the right one? Ah. I think that's right. That's why. These are not one size fit all. That goes up here. And this one goes down here. Okay. All right, I'm gonna scoot this back. And not break my mouse, apparently. All right. I'm gonna scoot this back and then I'm gonna put the computer upright so you can see it. Oh, that sound. Okay. That's the front of it. And I won't show you the back. I'll put the back on in a second. Actually, you know what? I'll put the back on now. Mainly because I don't feel like doing it tomorrow. So let's do it right now. There we go. And the fact that I'm going to be putting this off to the side for the time being until I can get back to doing this, because I definitely need to get this done before Wednesday. So, all right, computer is fully together for the most part. Let's plug her up, see what she looks like. If she lights up and does some whirly burly, then we're good. If she doesn't light up, then it's back to the drawing board. So let's do this. What can we unplug? What can we unplug to get the lights going? Let's see. I don't think this is long enough. I'm just gonna slap it over. That's plugged in. All right. We'll see if, let's see. Switch cameras, bring us close. Oh, switch the cameras, bring us close. Okay, well, let's see. I can, oh, gotcha. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah, let's. There we go. Sorry about that. Okay. So we are. 3, 2, oh well, I guess I can hit this switch first. Nothing. Hit the power switch at the top. Or is it on the front? I think it's at the top. Yeah, it's at the top. And we got power. Would you look at that? We got the fans going there. You can see the fans on this, up on this side here. Fans are going. We got light going to here, which is cool. Yeah. And, oh. You know what? I think would be a cool effect is if I turn the lights off. Let's see what that looks like. If I hit this light. Ooh, mood lighting. Let's turn it this way. Ha ha. And then it's got the power light on the top over on this side. Power light right there. Yeah. And it's not too flashy because of the fact that we want to definitely, this is going to be for the church, so it's not like it needs to be like RGB LED up to the hilt, you know, and all that craziness. So let me turn the light back on. All right. All right. That's the PC build right there. One stream. It looks like I don't have to come back and do anything. I'm going to put that plate. There's a plate that's supposed to go back here on the console back here. But I didn't put it on. So I'll put that on later. It's a snap-in plate, so it's not like it's detrimental to the computer or anything. Which, I actually want to know where it is now. So just snap it in now. Where is that? Anyway, I'll look for it later and snap it in. But thanks for sticking around. Thanks for hanging out and keeping me company while I do this. Again, this is one of those situations where it's not really part of the channel content. It's just something that I decided to do. If it gets a lot of views, if it, you know, makes a lot of waves, maybe I'll do more stuff like this. Maybe I'll contact some people, see if they want me to build a computer very clumsily. I don't think anybody's going to want me to build a computer for them with it, with the poor cable management that I have. But if they want me to do it on a live stream, I'll definitely do that. I have no problem with doing that. It was fun, and it was fun hanging out with everybody. So, yeah. Peace out. Keep making cool comics. Keep making cool stuff. Have a good night. Where's my mouse? I'm leaving all this in. Where's my mouse? I can't end the stream. Oh, there it is. Found it. All right.